someone. You got a fast car, is it fast enough so we can fly away? Still gotta make a decision, leave tonight or live and die this way.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's time to wake up and let the weirdness begin.
It's the KVJ show.
To start your morning.
Kevin is the host.
And his skin pigment is whiter than Casper the Ghost.
Virginia.
Sounds like this.
Nickname Vicious Beast.
So don't get her pissed.
It's Jason. Talks like a spaz.
And they love to talk about Bigfoot and stats. So get ready. Here we go. You're listening to 97.9 with the KVJ show.
Alrighty. Here we go. Hello and welcome to the KVJ show. It is Thursday.
Thursday. Remember back in college? Woo, nickel beer night.
Oh, I ever. I remember where I went to college. There was this really terrible beer from Pittsburgh called Iron City, and that was the beer that we got.
Better or worse than Natty Light?
I'd say probably a little worse.
Okay.
Probably a little worse, but it was very close, kind of on par with it.
Yeah, that's what we had. We had the Natty Light, but it was a nickel, man.
Okay. Yeah, you couldn't beat it. Honestly, I didn't know any better.
Me neither.
I never drank a decent beer until I was in my mid-20s.
Seriously, I didn't even know what that was until I was in my 30s.
Yeah, right. I hear you, man.
The first time I had a craft beer, I was like, whoa, it's so thick, it's so big, it's so robust.
It's a different game.
Yeah, it's liquid drugs.
It is. You're like, wait, this thing is 8% alcohol?
Mm-hmm. I'm not kidding you, they're at the 15% rate. And they taste like it.
Yeah. You can taste some of those strong beers, and it's a little too much.
Kind of like weed. Beer ain't what it used to be. You know what you make everything stronger these days?
Inflation stronger, beer stronger, weed stronger.
Well, I think that's all stronger because inflation is stronger. You've got to just drink and smoke your problems away.
We like things big, whether it's a meal or a buzz.
Or inflation. Well, not only is it Thirsty Thursday, but today is National Cereal Day.
Oh.
Very controversial topic.
Yeah, they were saying with inflation, I think it was the CEO of Kellogg's, maybe Post, one of those cereal
makers.
One
of those guys was telling you to eat now cereal for dinner.
For dinner, yeah. Yeah.
Well, I think he said cereal was a dollar. Cereal hasn't been a dollar seriously since the 90s.
No, the guy was massively out of touch. A dude with a $4 million a year salary was trying to tell us, yeah, you know what? Don't worry about inflation. Just eat cereal for dinner. It's all good. Everything you need in there.
The one thing I've noticed about cereal is that there are so many new ones out there that you've never heard of. Yeah. And I remember cereal used to be way better at branding. There's there's so many of them. You go, what the heck is that? You have to really look at it. There's a cartoon on it. It's confusing.
A lot of the ones that people are still seeming to at least look for and get are a lot of the ones you still already know. These are the most popular cereals via Google searches since 2004. So over the last 20 years, it's all pretty much name brands. But man, Rice Krispies is number one.
Get out of here.
Number one most sought after popular cereal.
Now, hear me out on this theory. Maybe it's number one trending on Google because so many people make Rice Krispie treats.
Yeah.
And
you're
seeing the recipes.
Yeah. When you add butter and marshmallow, it is pretty fantastic.
But let's not get this mixed up here. As a standalone cereal, it sucks. It's not very good.
Cheerios is number two.
Come on, man.
I think when you factor in everybody, man, when I was growing up, I know my parents, my grandparents, everybody had Cheerios, man. That was the staple.
It was. Cheerios was the big thing. And then I remember Because this happened in my youth when they came out with Honey Nut Cheerios.
Big deal.
My mom lost her S-bomb. Mm. She could not believe it because that hooker loved honey.
Mm-hmm. All I'm saying is this. If Fruity Pebbles or Cinnamon Toast Crunch is not in that top five, this is not a serious discussion.
It's not. No. In fact, the only sugary cereal was Lucky Charms at number five.
The worst of the sugary cereals, they're going to come
out. Yeah, the Google searches. That's what people are looking for whatever reason. I mean, maybe they're saying, why is Lucky Charms so terrible and it gets credit? I don't know. But, you know, that's Chex and Special K were the other two in the top five.
This is such a bogus list.
Well, I mean, it's just numbers, dog. It's just raw data. It's what people were searching. I don't know why they're searching it, but it's what they're searching for.
Virginia, it sounds like a hit piece.
It sounds like a nutritional piece. I mean, come on.
My question is, in the grand scheme, I know you love the sugary cereals, but what does the market dictate? Is everybody buying nothing but rot your teeth sugary cereals, or is a bulk of the cereal market for the healthier ones that are not laden with so much sugar?
Look, first of all, that's a good note. Brush your teeth after you eat your sugary cereal. You want to keep your teeth. But there's a reason why Fruity Pebbles and Cinnamon Toast Crunch is still available and still at
available,
the forefront.
Available, but is it true? If we looked at sales, do you think Cheerios is in the top five, Virginia?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you
think Grape Nuts beats some cereals that Jaybird loves?
There's no. I'll stake my entire reputation on the line when I say there's no way Grape Nuts outsells Fruity Pebbles or Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Okay.
There's just no way.
Well, I'll see if we can get those sales numbers.
Those numbers exist.
They do.
We'll never find them.
Well, we might. Well, I haven't looked for them yet. I'll give it a
kidding.
Shot.
Kev sounds like he's working for the man over here.
Well, he's the diet pansy. He does have a healthy agenda.
I got to balance out your guys' sugar agenda. It comes so strong. I got to say, you know, there are people that do try to eat food that is not so laden with sugar. It is possible.
You're very much right. I meet haters that go, dude, you got to stop talking about junk food. It's like drugs, man. I'm like, all right. Let's calm down.
Much like friends on the opposite table when it comes to sides of the table when it comes to politics, you two aren't going to see from each other's perspective.
We just come at it from different worlds, but
you
that's
do.
Okay.
You are right, though. I do come with a lot of energy and a lot of passion.
He does.
You're a
it.
Lot of sugar, and he's a lot of diet.
I got to be the voice for the unspoken here.
You're the polar opposite.
All right, I see you.
That's all it is. All right, we'll see if we can crack those numbers. So they would like you to have a bowl of cereal this morning or even for dinner, I guess, is how they look at it. Well, one thing I got to tell you, I noticed something today while going number two.
Oh.
It's something we just talked about. It doesn't have to do with a brand cereal, actually. I'll let you know. It's on my mind coming up next.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. Baby, my heart could still feel less hard at 23. And I'm thinking about of a hand. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day, and I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now take me into your loving arms, kiss me under the out loud. Maybe we found love right where we are.
When my hair's all but gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name, when my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. 'Cause honey, your soul could never grow old, it's evergreen. And baby, your smile's forever in my mind and memory. I'm thinking about
today, Jay Bird.
Well, I'm excited because it's Thursday. That means we have our Weird and Whatever podcast tonight. And I just want to thank the KVJ Nation for checking it out. Our numbers have been very good, so thank you guys for being a part of that. And we got it going on tonight. One of the topics we're going to talk about, there was somebody who, they're in their 60s, okay? Let me paint this story. They were out at a party, like a house party, barbecue style, and people were playing music, and there was a harmonica just sitting around. So this person picked it up just to kind of mess around. They've never played harmonica ever in their life, never even thought about the harmonica. Well, they fell in love with it instantly and kind of became kind of a prodigy with the harmonica and is really good at it.
Wow.
They're doing gigs with it, and they've only been playing for a couple years. And it brings up the point, do we all have some type of gifts inside of us that we don't even know about, that we've never even attempted to try? How do we know Kevin's not an unbelievable saxophone player?
I am. Oddly enough, that's when I started playing in third grade.
You just start to wonder, maybe because you're not interested in something, or you don't know about it, or you're not influenced. You don't know if you have those gifts because they've never even been they've never been stirred up. Do you think that's a thing? Do you think there's stuff in you that is amazing or you'd be good at that you don't even know about? Or do you think you kind of have your report on what you're capable of?
No, I think if I would have done some kind of musical, like, instrument, I could probably kill it on the piano because I have long witch fingers. They're skinny and long. My mom was a piano teacher, though. So growing up, she was always in our house giving piano lessons. And so I didn't love piano lessons. She would give them to me. I didn't love them. Or she was either giving them to other kids, and I didn't love that she was focused on those other kids.
Yeah,
so.
No, I would have a tough time parenting you if I was your mom.
I think I would have been good at piano.
Well, I'm not even talking about just music. I'm anything. Mm-hmm. You know, well, Denny's reminded me. Denny's was never a painter. And Denny's is a very good painter. His wife, Jen, got him into painting. And he kind of discovered, just by doodling around with her, he's a really good, that's a talent of his.
Amen.
So I think we all got hidden talents within us. We just don't know what it is sometimes.
Yeah, I think it's almost like a separate discussion. I think that we all do have hidden talents. We all have talents that are known. And then the prodigy level as a whole, I think, a different level.
It is. Mm-hmm. And prodigy is really kind of a once-in-a-lifetime type of thing.
Yeah.
But there are people who really pick things up quickly, especially
no doubt.
if you there's a thing. you can become healthy obsessive about something. There's unhealthy obsessive, and then there's learning an instrument and really getting into that.
Learning a language.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Kevin is obsessed with learning Spanish, but that's healthy.
When you do obsessive in a positive manner, you can really learn a skill pretty quickly.
Sure.
But you have to, it's got to be, there's got to be passion behind it.
Yeah, no doubt. Absolutely.
So we're going to talk a little bit about that, although I kind of just did the whole topic right there, so we're not going to do that tonight.
I've exhausted every angle.
Every angle. There's nothing else to squeeze from.
Done.
It. Wasn't that good of a topic anyway? Virginia, what's on your mind?
Well, I know today is National Cereal Day, but it's also National Panda Day. Today is my husband's birthday.
Oh, it is. Okay.
Whoop, 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 panda. I was shopping yesterday because, you know, I wait to the last minute. It's been a rough week. You know, this is one of those things that I love doing, and sometimes I forget to do, and then I go, oh, yeah, I'm doing that. I like going to the pawn shop because you can find some really cool things from some poor souls that were down on their luck and had to sell their good S-bomb because they needed money.
I don't think about that part, but, yeah, the pawn part's cool.
The pawn is that. People have to sell their stuff, so... I found a cool watch yesterday for him. So cool. And I know he's still sleeping, so he's not hearing this yet.
Okay.
But I looked on eBay, and these watches were going for like $500-$600, and I got it for $200.
Oh, you got a guy fresh off a gambling bender.
I did.
Yeah.
I got a guy who had already put his house up and his car up.
We were at station number one. I had to do a radio appearance at a pawn shop, and this was not a good pawn shop. This was a shady pawn shop, and the people that owned it, the people that went there, they were all so shady. It was 2 hours of the shadiest just encounters.
I love it.
I did too.
I am not afraid of shady. I actually am fascinated by the comings and goings of the individuals and the people working at the pawn shop. I'm telling you, that is so fun to me. I know they do like a reality show, but that's cleaned up and sanitized. You want some real gritty stuff? Go to Lake Park. Go on North Lake. Pawn King. I'm telling you,
Pawn
it's
King.
Gritty. There's people showing up to sell stuff. There's negotiations. There's like heated moments. It gets a little hot in there. I like it.
Every movie or every TV show that features a pawn shop scene, it's always the guy down on his luck,
yes,
trying to sell something. The pawn shop, I'll give you 200. What's worth 1,000? Take it or leave it.
200, 250 is the max.
No.
Then they're fighting. Oh, Kevin, it's so dramatic.
Oh, yeah.
Your wife would love it, too, because she loves to treasure hunt. And you can go in there and you can find. I was seeing, if I would have been shopping for myself yesterday, I probably would have spent way more. But I wasn't. I was singularly focused on Panda. But there was, like, cool designer stuff. There was Gucci stuff. There was Louis Vuitton stuff. There was men's Gucci sneakers that were so tight.
Kev, it sounds like someone got bit by the bug. This is how I got into garage sales and thrift stores.
Yeah.
It's so fun. And there is something to be said about the hunt. There's an addiction to the hunt.
But I would just say this to you. Don't go to a big fancy one, a clean one, a sparkly one. I know they got them in Boca. No, go to a gritty one.
Gritty.
Go to
30.
One on the edge
okay.
of town where
yeah.
it's not the best neighborhood, but it's not the worst neighborhood either.
You want a pawn shop that has a kill count.
Yeah, you want to yes. go where you can still sense people's pain.
Yes.
Yeah.
You want to go where there's a little desperation in the air.
Yeah. Oh,
it hangs like a fart.
I feel like that's every pawn shop.
Yeah, it needs to be close to a bail bond shop.
Yes.
Yes,
yeah. yes Kevin. You
okay.
know, you know.
I'm feeling it. Okay. What I got on my mind here today is I had a realization while I sat down to go number two. And I know a lot of people probably do. But the first thing that I noticed as I put in a new roll of Charmin TP, we've got one of those TP holders that's kind of embedded into the wall and it's fixed on size. It fit nicely. usually it's snug, and it takes a couple spins of that roll to get it to loosen up so that it rolls around. What does that mean, Virginia?
Shrinkflation.
Yes.
The price of toilet paper is going up, and the size of the roll is going down.
I'm not sure if the price has gone up, but it stayed the same, and I looked into it, and sure enough, Charmin toilet paper, which is what we use, now has 20 fewer sheets per roll, and I noticed this morning.
Look at that, your OCD kicking in. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's why you can't get anything past me, because everything is so anal and so precise.
This is why it's better to be drunk, because you wouldn't have noticed.
It's the beautiful thing of it. I said, wait a minute, what is going on?
Ever since we keep talking about this topic about how things are shrinking, I'm noticing it with so many things. A big offender is Pringles. I can't believe how many, they are really shrinking down the Pringle size.
Fake ass chip.
Look, I don't want to get into that debate, because I love Pringles and you hate them. It's more about the shrinkage.
It is.
Whatever, they suck.
Got a lot of it.
I don't want that fight.
Yeah, in fact, I saw earlier this week Cookie Monster got into it and was talking about shrinkflation, and his cookies are even smaller because they say the size of some Oreo cookies are now 6% smaller than they were in 2019.
Preach, Cookie Monster!
Cookie Monster's getting political!
Cookie Monster got political!
We see the shrinkflation. We're not stupid.
Yeah.
We know what y'all are doing. You're charging us more for an inferior product, a smaller product, a product with less expensive ingredients. We see you.
Is Cookie Monster Democrat because he's blue?
That's a great question. Yeah, he is right in the color.
Because if he's Republican, it's kind of confusing.
Right.
Because he's so blue.
Yeah, he is. You need to put on a red jacket.
Yeah,
at least. Yeah, they say that a family-sized box of Wheat Thins now has dropped 12% in weight, same price. So that's just what's going on, man. I think you'll probably notice about every product that you purchase, there's going to be that little, wait a minute, why is this thing?
Why is it smaller?
Yeah, it's so subtle, because it didn't look really any smaller, but when it fits so well, I'm like, wait a minute.
I'm dealing with the same thing right now, planning for Crawfish Fest. They repackaged crawfish tails. You know, if you buy them ahead of pack in a frozen thing, they used to be 16 ounces in the pack for a set price. Now, there's a 16-ounce pack, and it's a 12-ounce pack. And it almost tricked my sister. She was like, wait, look at the weight. It's 12 ounces instead of 16 ounces. Yeah. I'm like, oh, my gosh.
Yeah. You know, the same thing's happening with your musical act. The snack pack is playing less time, and you're paying us more this year. Shrinkflation, dog.
It's good. They do have a proposed bill out that could help the FTC crack down on shrinkflation. So they might be able to step in and start saying no, because it feels a little deceptive for the consumer to say, okay, announce it or something. Of course, they don't want to do that because then people wouldn't buy it. But that's where the deception comes in. And the Federal Trade Commission, that's what they do. They try to protect us from these kind of practices that are shady and deceptive. And
they've got to be working overtime right now. Can you imagine?
So many products.
So many every company, every major manufacturer is doing this across the board. It's not just TP. It's every product.
And we saw during COVID, we don't handle problems or issues when it comes to our toilet paper. We don't handle it well.
You're right.
Okay.
That was supposed to be that controversial of a statement. I don't know why I shut the room down.
Coming up here in a couple of minutes, I do have the numbers, Jay Bird. We were looking at the top Googled cereals over the last 20 years. You hated that top five list. But what about sales today on National Cereal Day? I will break it down for you coming up. And also, parents definitely want to stick around for this. There is a viable lesson you should be teaching your kids, and it's easy to do. I'll tell you what it is coming up.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Hey, West Palm Beach. Looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Now, during Staples' Print Big Sale, get $20 off your print purchase of $100 or more, $50 off your print purchase of $200 or more, and $100 off your print purchase of $300 or more. So, the more you print at Staples, the more you save. To demonstrate, print, print, print at Staples, you save, save, save. But if you print, 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 print at Staples, you save, 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 save. See how that works? Staples Print Big Sale. Print more, save more. Up to $100. Ends 4/6. Visit staples.com/print for details.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer, and now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
Injured in an accident? At Lytle Ryder, Smith, Ivey, and Fronrath, we have a team of attorneys with over 450 years of combined experience. With offices throughout South Florida, our team is ready to fight for you. You will pay nothing unless we win your case. Visit Lytle Ryder at foryourrights.com, main office, West Palm Beach.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
Voluntary pre-kindergarten is a great way to get your child ready for school. And did you know it is free? If you have a child turning 4 years old before September 1st, now is the time to apply. You can send your child to any one of nearly 400 locations in Palm Beach County. To learn more, call 561-514-3300 or go to everyparentpbc.org/VPK. That's 561-514-3300 or everyparentpbc.org/VPK.
What's holding you back from learning the language you've always wanted to know?
Too hard.
Takes too long.
Not with Babbel. Babbel's lessons take just 15 minutes a day.
15 minutes isn't long.
Nope, and they're fun. So you don't realize you're learning a language, but you are. In 3 weeks, you're able to start having conversations. And Babbel's lessons are built around real life.
And with Babbel, it isn't hard.
It's perfect.
Now try Babbel free. Just go to Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. Are you hungry like a hippo like I am? Very ravenous today. Let's talk Dunkin', let's talk donuts, let's talk some breakfast sandwiches and wraps. The wake-up wrap, my father's favorite thing at Dunkin'. He loves it. Makes him strong, it makes him peaceful. Don't sleep on the bagel minis. They're stuffed with cream cheese, and they are delicious. Download the app. It's going to get you deals galore. I'm Jay Bird, and I run on Dunkin'.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
Did you know that you can travel in the I-95 express lanes for free? With this program from the Florida Department of Transportation, you can. Carpool with two or more other people and ride the I-95 express lanes for free. Your smarter commute starts at carpoolmiami.com.
Be a part of the show. Mail at kvjshow.com or send us a message on the 97.9 WRMF app. Or just pick up the phone and call us. 877-979-WRMF. Now, back to the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Today is National Cereal Day. I gave you the top Googled cereals over the last 20 years. You had Rice Krispies and Cheerios up there and Chex and just a whole bunch of stuff that Jaybird did not approve of. He loves the sugary cereals.
You rattle off a lot of bull crap.
Well, what about the sales? What about the sales? That's what's really important. This really denotes what is the most popular cereal in America. What do you think is number one, Bird? Number one sold cereal in America is?
I'm going to go. I know it's wrong, but Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
You're going to go Cinnamon Toast Crunch? Oh, that is not correct. Do you have a guess, Virginia?
Oh, he's got a smuggy tone, so clearly he's got a health cereal.
Number one. Uh-huh. Is without a doubt.
Without a doubt. Yeah, without a doubt. Come on, bring it, sister.
Raisin Bran.
Oh, man.
What?
Yeah, no, I thought you were going to get it now.
Cheerios?
Yep. I had it all set up. I thought Virginia was in lock.
Oh, man.
Okay, I'll give you Cheerios.
Cheerios, number one.
They are great at branding. They You walk through the cereal aisle, heart health, heart health. You're not going to die if you eat the cereal. They're great at branding. I'll give you Cheerios.
Number two, Honey Nut Cheerios.
Damn.
It's a subset. I get it.
Cheerios know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Next, you've got Frosted Flakes.
Okay.
Number three, Honey Bunches of Oats at number four. Cinnamon Toast Crunch at number five.
Okay, this sounds like more of a real list to me.
This is based on sales, not Google searches.
You'll never hear me hate on Frosted Flakes. I'm a Tony the Tiger fan, baby.
Okay, Lucky Charms in at number six, Fruit Loops at seven, Frosted Mini Wheats at eight, Life Cereal, and then Fruity Pebbles round out the top 10 most popular cereals based on sales in America.
Wow.
Oh, that's interesting.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Dropping some real cereal knowledge on
you. And there's some bangers that are not in the top 10 that you left off.
Are you surprised by it? What would you say? What would be in your top three in sales?
If I was doing it, top three would be Fruity Pebbles, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Captain Crunch.
Okay.
One of the most underrated cereals out there is O's. O's is so good. They're these honey O-shaped things packed with just sugary oats and chemicals. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Chemicals.
Chemicals.
The sweet taste of cancer dancing on my tongue.
Look, it's delicious cancer.
That is just absolutely absurd.
They do
so
make
yummy.
Some cancer delicious.
I know. And look, I'm just I'm a victim of the machine.
Ask all the menthol ciggy smokers.
Right.
They love it, the sweet taste of cancer.
I know it's bad for me, and I still do it.
Yeah.
That means it's pretty effective.
Yeah, you know, you talk about the cancer sticks and the sugary cereals and all that kind of stuff. And I saw this meme I thought was rather entertaining. It says, why Generation X is the toughest generation? And it's because we all survived being raised like this. And it was nothing but photos of lawn jarts riding in the back of pickup trucks, parents smoking with the windows rolled up.
We were kind of the last generation of the old-timey ways of parenting.
It was pretty awesome. So we asked the question, what happened in your day that would never, ever happen today? We got some great responses from our Instagram and Facebook pages. We're going to share with you coming up next.
And I know she'll be the death of me. At least we'll both be numb. And she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come. But at least we'll both be beautiful and stay forever young. This I know. This I know. She told me don't worry. She told me don't worry no more. We both know we can't go.
And she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come. All the misery was necessary when we're deep in love. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. Girl, I know. She told me don't worry.
Happened today. I decided to ask the question after I saw a meme saying that Gen X is the toughest generation, and then it was just one screenshot after another of the way that we live, the games that we played, how we were just running like maniacs throughout the neighborhood, pitch black, all kinds of murderers out there. Parents didn't care.
You make the comment about lawn darts, and I think some people think that's a joke. That was a real toy they were selling to kids.
We had it. And it was a metallic spiked dart, and the wings of it were plastic, and you would hold the stick at the end and you would toss the metallic end and you try to land it in a hoop. But of course, the game all kids played, we would get around a group of us, three or four, we'd have someone throw it straight up in the air, and then you'd all take off running to see if it would come down and hit any of you in the head.
I get it
was a spear.
I get the excitement element of it, but
now I look at that, it easily could have killed. Not just maimed, it could have killed a child.
Totally.
We're in the backyard, and you know, my mom is doing the dishes and looking out the window, like, those kids, man, they're having such a good time. Look how well they play together.
Did it kill it? It might have killed a child.
I'm saying that it would have killed a child, and how our parents did not see the true danger in this game, unbelievable to me. And I think it probably had to take a kid dying before somebody said, you know what, maybe it's not a good idea.
It definitely had to kill.
The other one you brought up, parents smoking in the cars with kids with the windows up.
When I see
it now, it stands out so big. You go, oh my gosh, can you believe what they are doing?
You want to call DCF?
It's like in the last 20 years, we've had this great awakening where just, I don't know why, we had film over our eyes, blinders on. We just couldn't see what was coming down the pike. But I asked the question, what happened in your day that would never, ever happen today? And some of the answers were amazing off of Instagram and Facebook. Jeff said, when I was in elementary school, if you were student of the month, the principal would take you to get ice cream on the back of his motorcycle.
That's so suspect. Oh, my gosh.
Can you imagine seeing a kid driving away from school on the back of a motorcycle with no helmet on with the principal driving?
Guaranteed no helmets were involved.
That is amazing.
That is a great story.
Cecile said, when we had a birthday at school, the janitor would bend us over and spank us.
Dude,
that's, the janitor.
That's what, for in kindergarten back at my school, you would, for your birthday, they would bring you up in front of class and you had three choices. Do you get a hug? Do you get a tickle? Or do you get spanked?
Yeah.
That's not weird.
It's crazy.
No one thought that was odd.
A hug, a tickle, or a spank?
Yes.
You picked? So it's basically just foreplay.
You force the kid to go in front of the class, yeah, all the attention's on them, and then you have to pick your fate.
That's insane.
It really was insane, man.
Ian said when I was in second grade, the teacher had this uncanny knack of being able to spin, throw an eraser, and hit a child square in the face when they were talking.
Oh, my.
Tell you what, though. That class had the highest scores.
Yeah.
I seen that, too. There was a kid in one of my classes that got hit with an eraser. And back in the day, there was wood on one side of it. And I was like,
ooh. Yeah, right.
Well, to me, at that point, that's attempted murder. Because, mm-hmm. I mean.
Deanna said in third grade, my teacher would give out peanuts as prizes for math quizzes. Could you imagine doing that today with the peanut allergies?
You'd kill three kids.
Oh, my gosh.
You'd kill at least three kids.
Yeah.
Per day.
Yeah.
Sherry said at Jupiter High School back in the day, kids would pull up in their trucks with rifles in the back.
They might still do that.
Yeah.
Jupiter, there's yeah, a part no of Jupiter ever, that loved yeah, their guns.
No one even thought anything about it. Just know that as long as you didn't bring it in, you were good.
They grow them different in Jupiter Farms.
I just remember Jupiter, because I went to Palm Beach Gardens High School, Jupiter always had a country type of element. Not every part's of Jupiter, but oh yeah.
There was definitely a country element.
Jennifer said when I was a kid, my mom would give me a note so I could go to the store to buy cigarettes for her.
A note?
It was just a note saying, yeah, please let little Jennifer buy some Marlboro Reds.
It was a simpler time, though.
Yeah. Grant said when I was 13, I used to always drive my drunk parents home from the bar.
Oh, damn. That one.
I mean, the stuff you did back in the day, it's unbelievable. It's crazy. Now all of these stories would be in the Whacked Out News. I mean, it still happens, but it gets a special tag.
It happens, and then it becomes a national
story
now.
It's a national story. This was just what we used to do. Laura said, I used to sit in the front seat of my parents' Caprice Classic on the armrest so I could change the radio station.
Yeah.
No seatbelts.
Oh, we did not believe in seatbelts. No. as a culture. They had to do a whole campaign. Remember all that?
I remember.
Yeah. Stephanie said, I started babysitting when I was 10.
Dude, we've learned. We don't think you should babysit until you're at least 30.
Yeah, because I made some crucial mistakes as a 12-year-old watching two toddlers under the age of four.
Could you imagine a 10-year-old watching a child? That sounds so outrageous to me.
It's not safe.
It's all insane.
Or am I being a snowflake on that?
No, you're right. It's not safe.
All right, well, if you want to jump into the thread, it's on Instagram and Facebook. Just go and look for the KVJ Show. Subscribe while you are there. This is a really solid lesson. I thought, man, why is every parent not teaching their kid this? And it can be very easy as well. Chances are you probably haven't taught your kid, and you should. I'll tell you what it is next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart Screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Well, at the moment, no major incidents being reported on your roadways. 95 and the turnpike up to speed for the most part throughout Broward and Palm Beach counties. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
We pay the max. We pay the max. We pay the max. Let auto buy pay you the max. You're on your way to big fat stacks. We pay the max. We pay the max. We pay the max.
Get the max for your pre-owned car, truck, or SUV. Go to wepaythemax.com.
Recently, a new client called me and started by saying, Mr. Morgan, I really need your help, but I'm just a nobody. Those words stunned me, and I immediately called him back, and we're now helping him and his family after a terrible accident. I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Everybody who comes to our firm at their time of need is a somebody. I grew up poor, but my grandmother was like a queen to us. At Morgan & Morgan, our goal is to level the playing field for you and your family at your time of need. The insurance company has unlimited money and resources. You need a firm who can fight them toe-to-toe. For right at 30 years, we have fought them in courtrooms throughout America. Our results speak for themselves. And always remember this, everybody is a somebody, and nobody is a nobody. Visit ForThePeople.com to learn about our firm, Morgan & Morgan, For the People.
Injured? Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Do you hear that sizzle? Listen closer to that coconut shrimp crunch. Excite your senses during Seafood Fest with a limited-time menu. Catch it while you can at Bud's Chicken and Seafood. Yum,
yum. Fourth annual Jupiter Irish Fest is happening on Saturday, March 9th and 10th. Wear your green and bring your entire family out to Abacoa Amphitheatre to celebrate the Irish culture, enjoy authentic Irish food, learn how to pull your own pint of Guinness and sip on the finest Irish whiskies. You'll be able to listen to live Irish music on the Slane Castle stage, enter the costume contest, and much more. Get your tickets today at jupiteririshfest.com. General admission is $5. Children 12 and under are free. See you all on March 9th and 10th at the Jupiter Irish Festival.
Has losing weight been a challenge for you in the past? Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ Show, and I've never had much luck when it came to weight loss programs, but then I tried out Coastal Weight Loss Secret, and I loved the program. I dropped 30 pounds in just 2 months, and believe me, if I can do it, you can do it too. Dr. Adam Zuckerman and his team at Coastal Weight Loss Secret have a unique weight loss program that'll make it easy for you to lose that unhealthy fat, and you can do it without counting points or calories. There's no exercising, no surgeries, and none of those expensive prepackaged meals. Their program makes it easy for you to lose the weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. Then, once you lose that weight, they'll stay with you so that you can keep the weight off in the long term. This is the big thing I love about Coastal Weight Loss Secret. So many times you do a weight loss program, you lose the weight, and then you put it right back on. With Dr. Zuckerman and his team, they will make sure you have the healthy habits to keep that weight off in the long term. Schedule a free consultation today. You can reach them at 561-680-3090. That's 561-680-3090, or online at CoastalWeightLossSecret.com.
If you're the victim of a car crash, never rush to settle with the insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anajar and Levine. Call 1-800-747-FREE for a free consultation and take back control of your life.
In office, West Palm Beach.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Starting off with some patchy fog this morning, but that'll burn away this afternoon. For today, 80 degrees, we're partly sunny. Could pick up a shower or a storm, mainly into Palm Beach County. Into the Treasure Coast, we're generally dry. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by StormTight Windows.
When it comes to protecting your home, the choice is crystal clear. Get StormTight Windows and protect your home and family with South Florida's number one impact windows. Category 5 rated, StormTight Windows are steel reinforced for increased durability and security. If you want it done right, call StormTight.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Well, I'm pretty excited about this. I know Jay Bird's got a special affinity for Drew Barrymore, but I don't know if he got to see her show yesterday.
Did she get on her knees again?
Oh, my gosh. Yes, she did, actually.
Okay.
She did. Oh, my. Her energy. It's unbelievable. I mean, just her emotions on that show are wow.
Look, I think that she's super sweet and sincere.
Yes, I agree.
I don't think she's faking it, but I do think she's hamming it up, and I think she's reading the comments, and she knows that this is a polarizing thing, how emotional she gets with guests that she loves.
Okay, well, they had quite a reveal for her yesterday, and she lost her marbles. You'll get to find out what got her so excited coming up a little bit after the dirt here, which is just about maybe 15 to 20 minutes away on the KBJ show. It's a really good lesson. This makes a lot of sense. I don't know if you're teaching your kids this, but there are several experts that say they should know both mom and dad's phone number. We're in an era where you take phone numbers for granted and you just have them plugged in your phone. You don't think about them. I don't think I've ever once gone to my kids to make sure that if you didn't have any kind of digital technology around you and in a pinch, you could say off to somebody what mom and dad's phone number is.
Mom, dad, your address. It's stuff like that that, like, I don't know. You quiz the kids because not all of them know that.
I'm glad you bring this up because there's a lot of numbers I should memorize. And
right.
I know two numbers by memory. Uh-huh. My childhood house and the Kevin Ralston.
Okay. Hey, you got that.
I do.
Do you remember your childhood phone number?
I do.
What is it?
842-8907.
And what's Kevin's?
Gosh, I want to so bad.
Do
you
it.
Dared me.
I don't believe you know it.
I do know
I
it.
I don't think you know
I'll
it.
I'll write it down. I don't want to do Kevin like that. This ain't 2007.
Have you guys ever called your childhood number?
Yes.
Yes, have I?
Yeah,
yes.
I don't know that I have, and I was thinking about that. I'm like, I wonder who would answer, because I still remember it.
It's somebody going to be in Ohio, right?
It is. My parents, their area code changed, but the number's still the same from when I was a kid.
It's fun.
Yeah.
It's a fun thing to do. I've done it several different times in my life.
Okay. I might have to do that today. Fun little exercise. If you're saying, easier said than done. Here is a child expert, Emily Moore, talking about how you can get your kids to easily remember mom and dad's phone number.
Do your kids know your cell phone number in case of an emergency? Here's an easy way for them to remember. We're going to sing your phone number to the tune of Are You Sleeping? 517-517-339-339. 5032-5032, that's mom's number. That's mom's number. So we've been singing my phone number, just getting the song stuck in their head, and then they'll remember it. And don't worry, it's not my real number. It's my childhood landline.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably the first thing I've ever agreed with on TikTok. I think that's a great way for kids to remember stuff. That's how I would learn things, singing them back to myself.
Mm-hmm. There's another mom that set her phone number as the passcode to her son's tablet.
Oh, that's smart. Then he has to know it.
Right, yeah, because who knows he's going to be motivated for it.
That's very good.
Yeah.
Nothing is more important to these kids than those tablets.
Uh-huh. So I thought that was a good little piece of advice for parents out there if you're not doing that. Coming up in a couple of minutes, they're about to rule. They kicked it back on Friday. The governor said, I'm not going to sign this whole little parental regulation bill for social media. So they made some tweaks and they said, okay, we won't make it 16. Basically, it's kids that are going to be 13 and under that could be affected by it. But to me, it doesn't even sound like it's necessary. A couple of people sent in some texts that are pretty good about information you could know if you want to protect your kids from social media. I'll tell you what's up with that. And TikTok, man, hit down again. Some more bad news. I'll let you know what it is next.
Do it twice, hop the spark, you hold me tight. Get a taste.
Wrap up a legislative session in Tallahassee. What that means is they're going to try to cram a bunch of stuff in. And the one thing they've been trying to get done is this ban on social media for kids 16 and under. Kind of got there, got it to the governor's desk. He said, nah, I don't like it. Because, you know, he saw the numbers. 80% of parents really kind of want to make their own choices when it comes to their kids and what they do with stuff like that. So they kind of amended it a bit and they said, all right, well, we'll just basically have it affect kids 13 and under. And you know, we'll see if it winds up passing, but it could be that, yeah, nobody under the age of 13 could do social media in the state of Florida. And, you know, it is what it is. But to me, I like parents being armed with the ability to make their own choices and then educating parents on how to be proactive on that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think that is honestly the right way to do it. And I try to watch what my kid is doing. But yes, if there were some things that the apps provided to help make it easier for me to stay on top of it and make sure my kid only got the content I wanted him to do, I'd be very thankful. And a couple texts let me know that, yeah, that basically already exists. One person said, first of all, iPhones have screen time. Parents can control how much time their kids use their phone and can even control the time on each app. My daughter is 15 and still has screen time on her phone. She gets 40 minutes of Snapchat, Insta, Netflix every day. Then it gets blocked and she has to request more time. Most parents don't even know about this feature on iPhones. Ashley sent that in. That's really smart. If you did not know, look for screen time on your iPhones for your kids.
I mean, this sounds like you just got to be constantly involved in your kid's life, which, I mean, isn't that kind of what
parenting
is?
To me, yeah. If the legislators want to do something, just make sure that the processes are out there and then educate us as parents on how to use them so that we can be the effective gatekeepers. Let us be the gatekeepers, not the state.
I mean, I know I don't have kids, but the way I would look at it is, you don't want to be up your kid's butt and snooping and making them feel suffocated, but you need to be involved in everything that's going on. I'm sorry. You got to be.
Joshua said on Android, there are parental controls called Google Family Link. They can limit apps and screen time. So no matter what kind of phone maker you have, there are some options out there for you.
I talk a gang of crap about social media. Look, it's not going anywhere. I'm with you, Kevin. Let the parents parent. But people just need to know. It's like a drug, man. I'm sorry.
I agree.
It can mess with people's minds.
I think it needs to be tweaked. I think that we need to reexamine it. I don't think the concept of it is bad, but I think that it's gotten out of control. And so I do think it needs to be amended, and we need to help make sure that it's the right product for our kids, for mental health, and even for adults.
Just the days of putting your kid in front of a screen and letting them go rogue on the internet, I don't know if that's the move.
No, I agree with you. So I do like the concepts of the screen time and then parental controls on top of that. I got to tell you, though, as popular as TikTok is, and it seems to be, if not the most popular, one of the top two with kids, TikTok, Snapchat are up there, I know. Man, I'm telling you, I legit don't know if TikTok is going to be around in 5 years. I don't know if it's going to be around in a year. And I thought that was crazy probably 6 months ago. I'm like, there's no way. But there's a couple attacks that are coming from two different fronts on TikTok. One is the legislative. And right now, lawmakers are considering giving the President of the United States the power to ban TikTok in America. They're concerned about national security and the collection of data of Americans going to a Chinese company. So this bill would force TikTok to separate from ByteDance, which is the Chinese parent company. They don't trust them, saying, "Oh no, don't worry, Beijing.
Give them your CCP's security number.
They're not using this. We're never giving them information." They're like, "No, if they ask for it, they get it. So we don't trust it." So that's one front. The other one is TikTok losing all of its music. And that may be even more effective, because if it loses the cool factor, which the music definitely added that.
Definitely.
The soundtrack to TikTok. You know, on February 1st, Universal Music Group, they removed their entire roster of artist catalog from TikTok. And there's a lot of huge artists that they took off TikTok.
I noticed it yesterday or the day before. I was working on a video editing it, and I was trying to grab a Justin Bieber song to put underneath the Hailey Bieber thing we did.
Yeah.
And Biebs is tough
gone.
To get now. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Oh. Right. And now the National Music Publishers Associations, they say that their license with TikTok is going to expire on April 30th. They don't anticipate that it is going to be renewed.
Wow.
So they're going to yank everything that falls under the NMPA's jurisdiction off of TikTok. So they're going to lose even more stuff than they already have.
So does it go back to your old videos? And if you used any of that new stuff?
I think so. I think it
just
does.
What takes the audio out?
I don't know the technology. I don't know if they would just blank out the video or if they would yank out the audio.
There's definitely ways to go back and knock out audio of stuff. Look, they make the rules, man. They're going to do whatever they want to do that benefits them, not you.
Right.
And then they'll say it's legal because they just probably made a law making it legal.
Yeah, so that might be even the more effective hit on TikTok. So you'll probably at least see a change where music and audio that is not coming from the person creating the video, it's not going to be there anymore.
Oh, TikTok's going away. Oh, rants.
TikTok's never been nice to us.
I
love it for scrolling. I hate it for posting.
Yeah, I got my own personal issues with TikTok.
Yeah, I know a lot of people do, so you might not have it much longer.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, coming up in your Dirt of the Day, did you see where the jury came back with their decision on that Helena Hutchins murder?
Yeah.
They had the armorer, the young girl that was the armorer in court. What did the jury say? I will tell you coming up in your Dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation.
A major crash this morning has shut down 95 southbound in Palm Beach County. This is right before the exit for 6th Avenue South. Make sure to stay off the highway through that area. As for the turnpike, at the moment, no major incidents being reported. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Fargo, the new virtual assistant from Wells Fargo, makes banking faster and easier. Like this.
Fargo, what's my checking account routing number?
And this.
Fargo, turn off my debit card.
And this.
Fargo, what did I spend on groceries last month?
And that's just the beginning. Do you Fargo? You can. In the Wells Fargo mobile app. Learn more at wellsfargo.com/getfargo.
Terms and conditions apply. Your mobile carrier's availability and message and data rates may apply. Wells Fargo Bank, N.A., member FDIC.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer, and now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
No way. Boiled Tropicana's open till midnight?
What? Grab me a Tropi Chop.
Done.
Ah, forgot the cheesy yuca bites.
Got it.
You're looking out, bro.
I didn't say they're for you, though.
Boiled Tropicana. Real food, real fresh, and now, real late. Open till midnight. Hours may vary by location.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
Get ready, Boca Raton. The South Florida Food Fest and Craft Fair is going on all weekend long at South County Regional Park near Sunset Cove Amphitheater. Dozens of food vendors offering a la carte menus where all food is only $5 or less. Enjoy live music, food and craft vendors, a full liquor bar with craft beer and cocktails. A day filled with unforgettable flavors. Don't miss the South Florida Food Fest and Craft Fair this weekend. For tickets and more info, go to southfloridafoodfest.com.
Did you know that you can travel in the I-95 express lanes for free? With this program from the Florida Department of Transportation, you can. Carpool with two or more other people and ride the I-95 express lanes for free. Your smarter commute starts at carpoolmiami.com.
Dr. Rosenthal is amazing. He did my daughter's rhinoplasty. He did my girlfriend's lower facelift, that beautiful lift, in office without any general anesthesia. Yeah, she was awake the entire time, and Dr. Rosenthal let me hang out there in the office and watch the procedure. Wild. It was the coolest thing. And now my girlfriend, she's in her 50s. She looks like she's in her 30s, okay? That lower facelift, that beautiful lift is amazing. And Dr. Rosenthal has been doing beautiful faces in Palm Beach County for over 20 years now. That's experience. He's a face expert. I love an expert. If you're thinking about anything, eyelids, rhinoplasty like my daughter did, she loves her nose, or the beautiful lift like my girlfriend did with Dr. Rosenthal, they are ready to help you look your best and feel your best. They are gentle. Go to Rosenthal-MD.com. You'll be so happy you did.
Experience the Anager and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, it looks like it was the day of reckoning for Hannah Gutierrez Reed. She was in a courtroom yesterday facing the charges of not only involuntary manslaughter, but also tampering with evidence. They were saying that she tried to move things around after the shooting of Helena Hutchins on the Western movie set Rust. The jury came back and convicted her guilty of involuntary manslaughter, but not guilty of tampering with evidence. So if she faces the maximum, that could be 18 months in jail.
That's the maximum?
Yep. Involuntary manslaughter.
Is that pretty much every manslaughter thing?
No. I mean, you have different levels of manslaughter and your contribution to it. It just shows that she was negligent. They talked about it. I think she was partying a good bit, drinking and
she's young
using drugs and not,
reckless with yeah. weapons,
right. yeah.
reckless with bullets. I mean, a real bullet should have never been on yeah. that set. And she's probably a gun girl that was effing around and had guns at home, had guns at work, had bullets at home, had bullets work. Oh, which one is which? It was probably, you know, a sign of her youth, just being dumb. And they said that she was a affordable armorer.
Right. Yeah, well,
because she was so young and so inexperienced, she didn't come with the big price tag that the expensive armorers.
The testimony of one of the people on the stand was just saying that I'd never seen anybody be so reckless before. And yeah, they got what they paid for.
Yeah, you get what you pay for.
Yeah, and somebody's dead because of it.
Dang.
Yeah, that's what it's really going to establish. The civil cases are going to be stunning.
So Baldwin, he's in a good mood today.
It'd be interesting to see how this judgment sets him up, because keep in mind, he is the one that pulled the trigger, and as they do more tests on that gun, it doesn't look like there's no way that he didn't point that gun and then pull that trigger, which I guess is a big no-no that you shouldn't do.
So he's not out of the woods yet either, then?
Not at all.
Oh, got you.
He's saying he didn't pull the trigger.
Well,
he's saying the gun misfired.
They got a lot of ballistics people saying that did not. There's no way a finger would have had to do. They've had two different people, I think, analyze it here in the last couple of weeks, and they're going to be on the stand, and they're going to say that didn't happen.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't think it's looking good for him.
You're really involved in this case.
I do my work.
Yeah, you do.
I do my work. I'm on it.
I'm kind of still tuckered out from the whole Amber Heard, Johnny Depp. I put a lot of time into that one. I can't do two anymore court cases.
I hear you're done for.
I think I'm
the
done
decade.
For a minute. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, luckily you don't have to do them, Boo. I'll tell you what happened.
Very well done.
Somebody said that her stepdad, though, was one of the most well-known armorers in film. So
and that's probably how she got the gig.
Yeah, probably a nepotism type thing. And
she probably grew up around guns, and she's a young girl, and it was probably loose. Her stepdad's probably not loose.
Well, as soon as you said drugs and alcohol and partying, that right there, I mean, if they can prove all that, it's a slam dunk.
Yeah. Okay.
In other news, it looks like the woman who is saying she's got video of Prince Harry when he was on his fun Vegas bender and when he was out there like having a great time swimming naked and frolicking with strippers and who knows who else. That same woman who claims to have the video of him has now just sold a pair of his underwear that she kept from that Vegas party weekend. How much would you pay, Jay Bird? Let's play the fun game of Prince Harry's panties. How much would you pay?
I wouldn't pay anything, but I'll play your game. I think it's going for...
Let me explain them to you. So they're black boxers, and she has pictures of him in them and then not in them. And, yeah... You see him in the pictures with the knickers on.
You're really asking the wrong person. Knickers. I cannot stand royal stories. And I anywhere between $1,500 and $9,000.
You're low.
Low?
You're low.
Okay, $8 million.
Now you're high. No, she said she just sold a pair of his underwear for nearly $250,000.
Wow.
Who would want that?
A strip club bought them, and they're going to display them at the club and make a shrine and build a whole thing. It'll be a place. People will come as a pilgrimage.
So they're really, they spent $250,000 on promotion, really.
Marketing.
Yeah.
It's not a bad investment if you can get people to come and... It's a looky-loo thing. I would go.
It sucks if you do all that and no one really reports on the story, but it sounds like, I mean, you're reporting on it.
They're going to be in this place in San Diego. A strip club in San Diego bought them. I tell you what, if I was in San Diego and I had some free time and I knew the boxers were there, I would totally go to the strip club just to see those boxers.
I think they overpaid. I don't think it's going to get the hype they think it's going to. I don't know.
You don't think it's going to drive the traffic?
I think it is. I know they're trying to make it a thing.
Look, the place that is going to be displaying them will get a story out of it, and that alone, you could try to put a value on the marketing. Yeah, that got right.
And locally in San Diego, it'll be a story.
I might be bringing my own baggage in because it's a royal story. And
You hate the royals. You've got on record. I don't know what's going on here. Maybe you can tell me if you have any insight. Are Camila Cabello and Drake dating? I don't know what's going on, but they were vacationing together. Mm-hmm. They were hanging out. They were talking about their work. She was playing music for him. They were drinking. Like, it sounds like there's something going on there.
Yeah, she did the Call Her Daddy podcast, and here's what she had to say about it.
You were on a vacation with Drake.
Oh, gosh. Well, you know what?
I wouldn't say, like, straight up vacation.
Okay.
It was vacation plus some work.
Oh,
God. Have I ever had what?
Like a little thing with Drake.
A beautiful artistic collaboration with him? Well, I may or may not have. We hung out. I played in my album. But anyway, so I didn't like just go on vacation with him. It was like a vacation, like work thing.
Uh-huh.
They banged. They absolutely banged.
Think so, huh?
I don't need to hear no more.
It's definite. Okay.
That's a fun podcast, too. That Call Her Daddy has really come around for me. In the beginning, I didn't like it. Now I like it. Somebody coached Alex Cooper, and she's gotten way better.
Yeah, they got a lot of companies that do that.
It's definitely a fun show now.
She talked about Shawn Mendes and how they got back together.
It looked to the world like you and your ex, Shawn Mendes, kind of like dabbled with the idea of getting back together about a year ago.
Yeah. I just like, I'm kind of impulsive in that way, mm-hmm. I would say. It was a fun time. It was a fun moment. And, you know, and I will always care about him and love him. He's such a good person.
Yeah.
That's mm-hmm. what, Camila Cabello?
Yeah. She's hot.
Yeah. And then they asked her, too, why did you get back together? And then why did you break up like 8 hours later?
It wasn't even like a decision. And I think luckily, you know, I was in a place in my life where it took me less time. It took us both less time, mm-hmm. like to be like, this doesn't feel right. And we don't really need to like try so hard to like make it work. Like, it's all good. Let's be friends. I love you. Mm-hmm. It's all good. Let's move on.
Okay.
It's so mature.
They definitely hate each other.
No, you think?
That's
he probably longs for her. She's probably the one that got away. He probably saw those videos of her with Drake, and he was crying in his beer.
I think Virginia's off on this one.
I think he's doing all right for himself.
Yeah,
maybe he'll be fine.
He's not crying in his pillow.
He'll be
fine, but she's the one that got away.
Something tells me he'll be distracted quickly.
Yeah,
with somebody else.
New tale.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. And that's what's going on in your dirt.
Some celebrities having a birthday today include Lauren Prepon. She's 44. She was Alex Voss on Orange is the New Black. Also did a couple other shows. Was she on that 70s show too, maybe?
Yes.
Okay, I thought so. Wanda Sykes, the comedian, 60 years old today. Taylor Dane. I think she lived in Miami for a while, maybe still does. She did a song called Tell It to My Heart back
tell
in the day.
Tell it to my heart. Tell me I'm the only one.
No, I like the slow, sad one.
Oh, Love Can Lead You Back?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
That one's my cut.
Okay.
He likes to cry in his beer.
She's 62 years old today. And Bryan Cranston, Walter White on Breaking Bad, turned 68.
Also, Panda, my husband.
Yeah.
It's his birthday.
Sing a little Marilyn Monroe style happy birthday.
Happy
I was kidding.
Panda.
See what you did.
Oh, he'll get more of that tonight.
Oh, he will.
Me
and Kevin Ralston talk about it all the time. Panda's such a lucky guy.
A lucky guy.
I woke him up this morning when I was leaving for work.
Yeah.
Sweet kisses on his little neck.
Oh, yeah.
Nice, you know you like it.
Gosh, man, it just sounds so sexy.
Yeah. And happy birthday goes out to a baby girl, Panda. Happy first birthday.
Aww.
Same day as Virginia's Panda, the icing on why we chose the name for my boxer. Happy birthday.
All
the
so pandas. Cute.
That is adorable.
Edwin sent that in, and there's Panda. Looks like a panda.
Oh.
It's a dog birthday.
My what a gosh. Great looking dog. Yeah.
I want to kiss that snout.
Happy birthday to Sherry. Thank you for being my best friend and the best mom. That is Jace, who sent that in from Fort Lauderdale. Also, happy birthday to my grandson, Michael, turning 14. Love, Nana. Happy 14th goes out to June Bug. You make us proud, each and every day, even when you forget to do the dishwasher. We love you, Brandon. Love Mom, Dad, Hazley, Grace, and the pups. Happy 13th birthday to Sophia. That is from Mommy, Daddy, and Kenobi. Also, happy 12th birthday to little Maddie. Love you to the moon and back. Mom, Dad, Drew, Will, Captain, and Chubby. Also, Milani turning 5 from Mimi, Papa, Mommy, Aunt Madison, and Uncle Austin. And what a cutie, huh? Oh, look at her.
Adorable.
Oh, my gosh. Adorable. Yeah.
Happy birthday to Lori from Joanne. Happy birthday to my beautiful 10-year-old Caroline. That is from Mom, Dad, TJ, and Kennedy. And her cute photo on KBJ TV.
Cute.
On YouTube. Aww. All you have to do is just go to YouTube and look for the KBJ show. And you can find it. Okay, got a fun little game here. Jay Bird, I know pretty much every day you never miss it, but did you watch Drew Barrymore's show yesterday?
I did not. And Denny's was editing the clip and deliberately didn't edit it in front of me when I was back there. Because, Bird, you got to hear it for the first time live on the air.
Okay. All right. We're going to play a fun little game here because I know how much you love the energy that Drew Barrymore brings on her show daily.
Yes, you're a number one fan.
Okay, so listen. Please let the people know that you're being sarcastic. I really don't want people thinking I like that show. I don't. I can't. I can't have it.
His reputation's at stake.
Someone will believe you guys, and then they'll send me an email. You like Drew Barrymore's show?
And you're 5'4"?
Okay, this was Drew's reaction yesterday for a big surprise they had for her.
I have a gift for you. In 3, 2, 1, remove the blindfold. Ah!
I'm
trying
to talk.
Oh, but you're
dressed.
We brought.
It's so nice to meet you.
I can't believe it. I'm going to get so excited. Let's
do it. Okay. All right.
I get it.
A lot of exuberance. Okay. What happened to Drew Barrymore?
What went down, Jay Bird? I know you watched it.
Okay. What is the correct answer here? Was she A, reunited with director Steven Spielberg for the first time since E.T.? Was she told that she will be the first person to ever do their show live from space? Or C, was she told that she gets to ride in the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile? A, B, or C, that excitement came from what?
Oh, my gosh.
What do you think it could be, Bird?
Oscar Mayer?
See, all that for a Wienermobile?
I can see her doing that.
That excited for the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile.
Look, I have so much to say about this.
Okay, don't worry. I'm going to let you go off here. But you clearly heard the excitement. It's got to be something massively huge. Why was Drew Barrymore so excited yesterday? You will find out next right here on the KBJ Show.
Innocent say I keep a check. She was a bad bad nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, you're a wreck. Stuck by you. You're the sunflower.
I think your love would be too much, or you'll be left in the dust. Unless I stuck by you, you're the sunflower, you're the sunflower.
Very exciting day. Very exciting day for Drew Barrymore on her show yesterday. They had a huge surprise for her.
I have a gift for you. In 3, 2, 1, remove the blindfold.
Ah! I was gonna say, we had to move mountains to make this happen.
Oh, but you're dressed. We brought.
So nice to meet you.
Mountains.
Oh, it's nice to meet you.
Okay, yeah.
Well, so, I could have been the hot dog, the operator, dog wiener mobile operator.
Yeah, you never know. Yeah, and it could just
Spielberg.
It's not Spielberg.
Well, it could have been a handler that was right there too. So you know, a lot of times people don't travel alone.
Oh, hot dog handler. Or a Spielberg handler. Or a handler of Spielberg's hot dog.
Could be, yeah.
Well, I get it. I'm self-aware enough to know that I am extra as well. So I'm being hypocritical calling Drew Barrymore out for being oh so extra. But I don't know. Her extraness just, it rubs me the wrong way. I don't know what to say.
It's sweet and genuine, but it is annoying.
See, I think the complete opposite. I don't think it's genuine.
Oh, Jay Bird.
I think it's calculated.
I think she tries too hard.
I
think it's really how she is, but now she hams it up because she knows people are talking about
it. Well, hamming it up isn't being genuine. Hamming it up is hamming it up.
But when it started, it was real.
No.
It's real.
No, you're it's a parlor trick. You're tricked too much, Sinicky.
Okay, so was that Drew Barrymore being reunited for the first time since E.T. with director Steven Spielberg?
We don't think it's that one, Kevin.
Was it her being told that she's going to be the first person ever to do her show live from space?
That would be cool, first of all.
And that's huge.
That is huge.
Yeah, that's big.
That's not that cool.
You're bringing in your hatred for space into this conversation.
Yeah, you're right. Forever be known.
I like Drew more than I like space. Space is dumb.
Or was she being told that she gets to ride in the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile?
I'm sticking with Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. Okay. It's such a big reaction. And
Huge reaction.
And it shouldn't be the Oscar Mayer Mobile, which makes me think it's that.
She was that excited for the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile.
Good job.
And I get it, because I would be, I'm torn here. I'd have the same reaction.
And it's nothing but a shameful plug, because Oscar Mayer has come out with meatless hot dogs and they want to introduce them on national TV. It's their not hot dogs made of plant-based meat, and they wanted a really excited person to help them reveal them to America.
Founder.
This ain't calculated. This is genuine, Virginia.
She likes a meatless hot dog. Get
out of here. Kevin knows what he's doing. He likes to play things that make my blood boil.
I mean, that's your take.
This is why I've gotten emails from people that are saying the things I'm saying about Drew Barrymore about myself. So it's a weird place to be.
He's in a weird moment.
Yes. It is. Mm-hmm. I get it. I'm a hypocrite.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, I don't know anybody else that's going to respond like that. So, I mean, she's got to be one of the top pitch people now in America after that emotional reaction to meatless hot dogs.
I know one other person that have a reaction like that, and I'm struggling with that.
Okay.
It's me.
Right. Yeah. If we wheeled that Wienermobile over here and he wanted to ride in it and get to do all kind of fun stuff in it, it is impressive. I've been in the Wienermobile. When you see it and you're next to it, you're like, whoa, this is awesome.
You see when Virginia surprises me with a baked good or she makes something and she gives it to you. Yeah. I'm genuinely excited and happy.
Okay, well, there's a bunch of new products. It's not just the meatless hot dog that's coming out from Oscar Mayer. It's a couple things. How about a Cheez-It flavored ranch dressing?
Ooh.
Okay. All right. That's big. That's big.
You have to play that clip throughout the entire show.
Anytime any mundane thing is announced, you must hit that sounder.
Virginia, I'm ordering breakfast. Virginia, Suits is getting a haircut today. That is fun. I'm so jealous you have all the buttons right now.
That's amazing.
I'm not done, though. There's a lot of other great products coming out, thankfully. Not
more
just
than
the
just
cheese,
a meatless hot dog.
And the Cheez-It flavored ranch dressing. Campbell's is also doing a limited edition grilled cheese flavored tomato soup. I'm excited. Yes. You and Drew Barrymore. So excited.
No, I really am excited.
The soup is going to taste like tomato and grilled cheese.
Yes.
That's his favorite combination.
Now, what the heck is going on?
Real talk.
Can you believe it?
That's amazing.
That's amazing.
That's amazing.
Yes. And how about this? This month, IHOP is selling Girl Scout Thin Mint pancakes. I know how you feel about Thin Mints.
A lot of people love Thin Mints, though. That is the most popular cookie. It's a smart move.
Oh, it'll do great.
It'll do fantastic.
Please don't lose that clip.
Okay, I won't. And did you know that Dr. Pepper is partnering with Coffee Mate to create the perfect dirty Dr. Pepper? I mean, there's just so much exciting news out there, isn't there?
Yes, there
so
is.
So much stuff.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart Screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Following an earlier crash, 95 southbound has reopened at 6th Avenue, but you still have a left lane blocked in that area, and you're seeing fairly heavy residual delays. Give yourself extra time this morning. As for the turnpike, no major incidents have been reported so far, just a little sluggish in the area of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose two of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious small fries for only $3.89. Now my day is made the tastiest way when I bundle and save at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid when product served.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is, but the rest of your body, oh yes, it's gonna relish every moment of it. Because there are drinks, then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Strax Aesthetics, the foremost name in cosmetic surgery, is now offering unbelievable pricing for tax season. Breast augs from under $100 per month, tummy tucks from under $200 per month, and gastric sleeves for excess weight loss as low as $300 per month for qualified patients. All surgeries are performed by renowned board-certified surgeons. Strax guarantees to beat any qualified comparable surgeons. And Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price for services. View surgeon bios and past work by visiting StraxPlastic.com or call 954-749-3040 for a free consultation.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
It's a big deal, and it's an amazing thing that they are offering right now at Life Imaging FLA. We've heard the stories, the testimony of people that have gone to have the heart scan done at Life Imaging FLA. They thought they were healthy, and the news came back, oh my gosh, you have a major blockage. And they rushed people from Life Imaging FLA to the hospital for emergency life-saving surgery. This is real, and this is happening, and these people wouldn't have known about the blockages if it hadn't been for Life Imaging FLA.
And it's so ridiculously easy to do. It takes 10 minutes. There's no dyes, no need to undress. There's just a few minimum requirements, and you can find out the answer. It is free, a $699 value for you.
Go and do this for yourself. Do it for your peace of mind. Do it for your family. You know, 30 to 40% of heart attacks, the first symptom is sudden death, and you just drop.
All you have to do right now is from your cell phone, call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Starting off with some patchy fog this morning, but that'll burn away this afternoon. For today, 80 degrees, we're partly sunny. Could pick up a shower or a storm, mainly into Palm Beach County. Into the Treasure Coast, we're generally dry. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Last year, more clients hired Morgan & Morgan than ever before. We now have more offices, more staff, and more lawyers than any other injury firm in the world. Protecting America. Fighting for you.
Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Dunkin' Donuts, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF. What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Well, there's a lot of awesome stuff happening this afternoon. Danny and Megan hooking you up with a ticket that your kids are absolutely going to love. Shrek the Musical is coming to the Kravis Center, and they got tickets for the showing on April 27th coming up this afternoon. So make sure you are here at 97.9 WRMF. You can also download that free app right now as well, and that will give you the hookup so you can stream them live for those Shrek tickets coming up here. Well, there's a couple different options here for you. Tell me which you would rather do of the two. Would you rather have to shower every day in scalding hot water or in freezing cold water?
You got to go freezing cold. Scalding hot is going to burn you.
I could not disagree more. I love when it's hot like that. I had to have people come into my shower to make it as hot as humanly possible.
Oh, really?
Because okay. The heat wasn't enough for the bird. I like it weirdly hot.
Scalding?
You would your skin would fall off with what I know. It sounds like I'm bragging right now, but I like a hard, hot hoes.
Ooh, that didn't sound good.
What? All right, all you hoes out there.
Hot stream is what I mean. That didn't sound good either. I'm back out of this convo.
Okay, would you rather have spaghetti for hair or sweat mayonnaise?
Ooh, spaghetti hair sounds awesome.
Okay.
What do you think, Bird? I would date a girl with spaghetti hair.
Yeah, without
a doubt.
I'm feeling like spaghetti hair would be thick.
Would she catch you cutting some off, though, onto a plate with some marinara?
I wouldn't date you with my mouth.
If she was into it, with consent, of course.
Of course, yeah. Yeah.
Butter that girl up.
I mean, Kevin, now you're just turning me on.
Sweating mayonnaise would be so gross.
Oh, that can't be the right answer.
Well, mayonnaise out in the air for 5 minutes is gross and starts to sweat on its own.
Look, yeah. I don't even know the person that I was in the 80s and the 90s. I loved mayonnaise. I have completely flipped on mayonnaise. 100% completely flipped. The only place that I like mayonnaise now is in a deviled egg.
To the witch's point, Virginia is right. I have changed my attitude towards mayonnaise. I used to go to Subway and get tuna subs
extra, and
then have them put extra mayo on.
I know.
The mayo would squirt out of this.
It's that insane.
Makes me so nauseous to think
about.
I
would barf if I had to eat that now. I used to get Whoppers with extra mayonnaise when I was in college.
I still like it, but it's not the love affair I once had. It's pretty gross.
It's disgusting. Just mayonnaise by itself. Ugh.
Hey, Drew, do you like mayonnaise? Okay, Drew Barrymore likes mayonnaise. At least there's somebody that still loves it. It's good. Okay, what about this? Would you rather have eyes that can film everything or ears that can record everything?
Ooh, I like that.
What would be better? Now, audio could be damning, video as well. In fact, I often get disappointed when I see video and there's no audio with it.
Well, yeah.
But I think video is more convincing than audio.
I'm with you. I'm going to go video.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I have a lot of audio on my phone because I like to tape people secretly and not tell them. But I think video is more important.
Be honest with me, please. Have you ever secretly recorded me or Kevin? Be honest.
No.
Neither one of you. That would be not cool.
Well, you guys are cool. You know who I've secretly recorded.
I'm not coming up with this conversation
anymore. I know, right? Because we're about to be implicated in a crime.
Dog, this is a live broadcast.
But off the record, you know.
I guess. I hate it, Kevin.
I can't say, but there's certain situations where you have to protect yourself.
The only one I truly know about is one you recorded about 12 years ago or 10 years ago.
That's one. But
that's the one I know about.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
But if you do it once.
Academy Awards coming up this weekend. So would you rather be an extra in an Oscar-winning movie or the lead in a box office bomb?
Box office bomb.
The lead in a box office bomb? Okay, I'm going to go the other way. I'm going to go an extra in an Oscar-winning movie because that would impress people when you would say the name. Be like, yeah, I was in so-and-so, and you're not lying. And you could then maybe show them, hey, that's me. And they'd be like, oh, my gosh, that's so cool.
You can still have a good performance in a box office bomb, and that's what you'd have to bank on.
Okay, what do you choose, Virginia?
I think I want to be the star, like Jay Bird.
Okay, in the bomb.
I'm not here to be an extra, girl.
Well, there's some movies that were bombs, but the lead did a great job, and they got work because of that.
Yeah, I'm here to be the star.
Oh, okay. You guys are stars. All
right. yes, we are. Did you see the KBJ horror movie?
Yeah. Okay. Have you seen the one where I was green?
I'm not sure he has seen the horror movie.
He's in it, and I don't think he's seen it.
No, he's the big scene. He's the big reveal.
He's busy.
All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, we had a female umpire at the ballpark of the Palm Beaches that is hoping to make the big leagues this year. And that is the first time they've had a female umpire since 2017. It's a big story.
Okay, girl, we see you working. Yeah.
But is it possible that a woman would ever make the major leagues to play, not just to referee? Well, there's a video game kind of pushing the agenda. Are they right, or is that just a pipe dream that would never happen? We'll discuss coming up next. I said, are you serious? I try, but I can't figure out. I've been next to you all night and still don't know what you're about.
half your age. Yeah, you looking at me like I'm some sweet escape. Obvious that you want me, but I said I would want myself. Let me please you, baby. I'll play you through hell. Just know me, yeah, yeah. So sure of yourself. Baby, don't get greedy. That I want as well. Ooh, and well. He said, I'm just curious. Is this for real? Just and I can't tell if you love or hate me. Never met someone.
Will there ever be a woman that plays in the major leagues in baseball? There's a video game that if you like baseball, you're probably playing. It's called MLB The Show.
It's my all-time favorite video game. I'm a major fan of this franchise, and I put quite a bit of money into this product.
Well, they're making their main storyline about a woman making it to the big leagues.
Entire sports world taking notice.
Whatever your big league dreams, they're yours to unlock in Road to the Show. Unlock your dreams.
And it shows a girl growing up to a woman and then other women that are playing in the show. Now, to me, it seems like good marketing to get girls involved and to, you know, going ahead and let's have that dream be a dream. That would be absolutely amazing. But there are many hardcore fans that are saying that they're now boycotting MLB The Show because they feel like an agenda is being crammed down their throats that they don't like.
See, none of that stuff makes me mad. It really doesn't. The way I've always felt about this stuff, if you are good enough to play, you're good enough to stay. No matter what's between your legs, if you're good enough, you're good enough.
Yeah.
That's just the way it should be.
Yeah.
Now, I'm annoyed and upset because I see this as a cheap parlor trick. As a fan of that franchise, there are so many problems with that video game that they are not fixing, and it's making me not love the game. And they're getting all this hype by adding the storyline, and they're not fixing the main problems of, I mean, I don't care about the storyline. They're going to have an option of you being a guy playing the storyline. So if you don't like that storyline, just don't play it.
Yeah,
I don't like the fact that they're getting all this hype around it, doing a cheap publicity stunt, and they're not fixing the main problems of the game. That's what's annoying.
Okay, so there are other little things that they need to take care of before they do something like this.
Well, they're getting a lot of media hype about it because of people are mad and upset. I'm annoyed because...
So they're going on rage stuff. They know if they do something like this gender-wise that people get all upset.
Gender rage works. It works really well for me.
It works. It's going to get people talking, and that's fine. I don't care. Whatever. Again,
it's me. Lots of high fives in the grocery from the women. Yeah.
I say don't fall for that because it's designed to get you mad.
I don't even understand why somebody would get upset with that. So what? They put women in playing Major League Baseball in a video game.
They should be at home in the kitchen making me a sandwich.
I think the main thing is that they're over the top trying to throw it down your throat when they're not fixing other main game problems as well.
Yeah, I don't understand the ins and outs of the game and what they got to fix. But I mean, as far as doing that, I can't even imagine why you'd be upset. I don't even know. I wouldn't even pay attention to it. Now, I mean, it does bring up a question. Do you think that a woman will ever play in the major leagues if that's what maybe it's supposed to do, is to stoke the dreams?
I think it's heading that way. I think if somebody was good enough that could look, it's a high level of a sport to play. There's very strong people up there. If they're able to get up there and compete and stay in the league and be able to do it, why wouldn't you be able to play?
Yeah, I taught and coached travel softball for a while with my daughter.
Bragger.
And, Yeah, that's is that a flex?
Well, Kevin's flexing over
to win the Gardens Championship ages 9 through 10.
Yeah, so I coach 12-year-old girls. Yeah, you know, no big deal.
Look, we did win the championship.
Yeah, okay, we did. No, you're right.
I was an assistant coach.
Yeah. But the one thing I saw, there were a couple girls that had played baseball up until around the age of 12 or 13, and then they came over to softball. And the reason why was because strength was becoming an issue. And in my time coaching and even seeing my daughter who went on and played a little bit in college, she has a friend that's getting ready to go play Major League Softball. She did very well playing Division I. This girl could crank home runs, won 4 state championships and everything else. She couldn't play in the major leagues.
Yeah, I mean, this happened so many times in college where they would sometimes make the baseball team play the softball team, and the softball team, the schools that I went to, they were really, really good. They would win championships, and it was a bloodbath.
Right. I mean, there just is. And, hey, look, if it ever does happen, I think it would be, wow, what an amazing story. And I love that MLB, the show, is actually doing this so that maybe girls could dream and, you know, maybe there's a way that it could one day happen. But I don't think it's necessarily realistic with where we are now.
The way if you can play, you can stay. Just you got to play.
I agree.
You got to be good enough.
If you can rip them boobies, rip them.
I've always believed that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I don't understand the rage. It probably does help market the show, though, and people are probably going to buy it because of it.
People get very mad online about stuff, and
I know.
Dude, we love a gender war.
It's just silly because, man, we got a lot of problems and what people get upset about.
Virginia's not wrong, man. The gender, any kind of division, whether it's race, whether it's gender, age, young versus old, it just makes everyone, it's not about bringing people together. It's all about tearing people apart.
No, it's not. Well, everybody does have a strong opinion about a lot of things. Many of them really don't matter, but that's what we're going to talk about here. We always love to hear yours. What is a random thing that you've got an unusually strong opinion about? Is it about MLB The Show? Catering to women, how dare they?
Get in the kitchen, woman!
877-979-WRMF. You can text in yours now on the KBJ Show.
Let's get it. We got to get it wrong. Mary J is in the spot tonight, and I'ma make you feel alright. Come on, baby, just party with me. Let loose and set your body free. Leave your situations at the door. So when you step inside, jump on the floor. Situations at the door, so grab somebody and get your ass on the dance floor.
J. Blige, she was on with Hoda Jenna yesterday morning on Today. Jenna Bush Hager apparently doesn't really understand the anthology of Mary J.'s albums because she referred to her second album as her debut album, and Mary J. had to kind of correct her on that.
Boy. Don't even.
Yeah. Gosh, this always sucks when you're interviewing somebody and they got to correct you about how wrong you are.
Well, you're reading it off a card.
Right.
Maybe give the interview to somebody who actually is a Mary J. fan.
Yeah, and then they try to get the scoop, the skinny about Mary J.'s dating life. She kind of shot that down.
So are you dating?
Yep.
We got it. Yep.
That's it. That's it.
Okay, there you go. All right. Yep.
What do you think I'm doing? I'm Mary J. I can date whoever I want.
Next.
Get my album right and shut up.
All right. Well, we love the random strong opinions. Just went into the opinions that some fans of MLB The Show have about their new storyline going after women and putting ladies into the big leagues. And, of course, that's got some people outraged. But what other random things do you have an unusually strong opinion about? One person texted in, they said, I hate that people in movies never take a moment to lock their car when they park. It makes me want to yell at the screen, but I know the whole theater would think I'm a maniac.
I got one, and I'm not sure how y'all gonna feel. I'm sorry. When it comes to washing dishes, it's way better, it's more effective to do it hand to dish than the dishwasher. Dishwashers are overrated and don't work as good as your hands. Can I get an amen on that?
That's true, but I don't have time. The dishwasher saves us time.
And I think old school grit is better. I think dishwashers can never compete.
I agree with you. Old school grit also uses a lot more water, believe it or not.
Okay. This one says, I don't think kids should be taken out of school to go on vacation. Go on vacation when they already have the school days off.
Oh. Whatever. Okay. Sometimes Mardi Gras just happens when they don't have off here.
Didn't you feel like that might be a shot fired?
You ain't telling me nothing.
Yeah, they're not changing Mardi Gras.
If it's Mardi Gras, you will not see my Floridian kid.
I kind of like this random thought. This opinion is kind of interesting. It says phones should automatically notify you if you have been put on speaker. There's nothing worse than thinking you're having a private conversation when you're actually talking to a crowd.
That is a good one. I think that's good for everybody because sometimes I'll be on the phone. I put everybody on speaker. So if you're talking to me, guess what? You're on speaker.
Ah.
And I feel like sometimes people just start saying stuff and I'm like, whoa, you're on speaker. You're on speaker.
I would love every connection to show if you're on speaker or not and how many humans are within earshot.
And
ideally, if you could do it, give me the names.
I remember I was on a road trip with a couple. We're all driving to this wedding destination thing, and they start talking, and the husband, I didn't know him that well. The husband took a phone call on, and it was a woman he worked with, and he had it on speaker. And in front of his wife, he goes, "Hey, blah blah blah. Just want to let you know you're on speaker. My wife is in the car." And when the call was over, she goes, "Why did you have to say all that? Why did you have to let her know that I was in the car?" And it turned into an awkward fight.
Right.
Yeah, it was weird.
Wow. Yeah, that's why I would never pick up a call on speaker. I would just put it to my ear and be like, that's what it is. I think that they deserve that level of privacy.
I think the phone causes brain cancer, so I'm not holding it to my ear.
You know that for a fact about this brain cancer?
If I had to get yelled at from my wife why I had to make that announcement or brain cancer, I'm going to choose brain cancer.
It's I understand.
How scary is your wife? That's what it is.
Yeah.
If you're more afraid of your wife than brain cancer, hold the phone to your ear.
There's a lot of people listening that goes, if I had those two, I'm more scared of my wife.
Give me brain cancer all day on Tuesday.
Panda would say the same thing.
He would say the same thing.
I know.
A random strong opinion here. There should be a feature on eBay where you can send a middle finger emoji message to the person who outbids you at the last second.
The secret to that, it's an app called Sniper. And you pay for it. And what it does is it waits till there's like 3 seconds left in the auction and it automatically bids for you. You put the maximum that you'll do, and it will snipe your bid every time. My girlfriend's got it, and whenever I feel like I need to snipe somebody, I just Venmo her the money, and she snipes
but
it for
I've
me.
Tried to do that before, and it didn't work, because what happens when you have a group full of snipers? They're just sniping everybody.
Snipe on snipe?
I was involved in snipe on snipe crimes.
If you have a snipe on snipe situation, I think it's just timing.
Well, that's what happens every single time.
How good is your snipe?
Everyone's got snipe. Then snipe is weak.
It renders itself ineffective.
That's the stupidest thing ever. I hate sniper.
That's your opinion.
It's my opinion.
Yeah. Here's another random strong opinion. Chlamydia would actually make a cute name for a girl.
Oh, get out of here.
For a nickname you call it chlamydia?
If you could remove what you know chlamydia is, does it sound pretty?
I'm trying to think of Nick Clements.
I can't remove it. You're asking the impossible.
They did take some time with those STD. Gonorrhea. There's no way that sounds good.
Gonorrhea does, but chlamydia?
Chlamydia sounds bad, but you're right. Am I just...
Are you so tainted by knowing what it is?
Chlamydia Pennington. I don't think I like that.
Okay. Barbers and taxi drivers should offer an extra charge not to talk for the duration of the haircut or ride.
You can put that in on your app now on Lyft.
Yeah.
It says, what do
Smart.
You want? You want a? I always put cool ride, quiet ride.
There was a barber place. I had to stop going because the woman that was cutting my hair would not. It would take an hour and a half because she would not stop talking. And then I think she was on drugs.
Ah!
Okay. She kept on leaving to have a smoke break. It was insane.
Mm-hmm. Facial and neck tattoos are tells that this person is an absolute idiot who is best to be avoided. Uh-oh.
Better watch yourself, Ralston.
I don't know if idiot's the right word I would use. When I see a neck or face tat, I'm like, okay, this person is definitely hard, and I do not want to F around and find out. I give them a different level of respect because I think it's just a bold move that tells me you're bolder than me.
You do when you, the face tat, I think, is more, you do mentally go, I think they're probably tough.
They're tough.
Something in their life made them tough.
I can't hang with them in any kind of like altercation, scuffle, they're going to be stronger than me.
I think the worst would be is to get a face tat really, really young. And then, I don't know, at 28, you kind of, I don't know, sober up and go, what did I do?
Have you seen Amanda Bynes? She has face tats.
Now, if you love your face tat, that's different. I'm saying the regret. If you go, oh my gosh, I have a
where's Post Malone? Where's Jelly Roll? How are they right now? I'm feeling about their tats.
They're different because they're celebrities. They got money. They're not going to be. I'm talking about the guy that got the tat when he was 19 and really grew out of just getting face tats, and now he's a completely different person.
There are amazing advancements in laser tattoo removal. So just hold on to that hope. If you got that face tat, you can get rid of it.
It works?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It works. It's painful.
It hurts like the Dickens. But
it hurts, but it works. And how bad do you want to get rid of that teardrop?
All right, any other opinions you have, text them in to us, 877-979-WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart Screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Following an earlier crash, 95 southbound has reopened at 6th Avenue, but you still have a left lane blocked in that area, and you're seeing fairly heavy residual delays. Give yourself extra time this morning. As for the turnpike, no major incidents have been reported so far, just a little sluggish in the area of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer. And now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to Ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
Want more speed? Then you're in luck, because Xfinity just increased their internet speeds, and they're faster than ever. Plus, with super fast internet and a reliable connection, you can do more of what you love whenever you want. More gaming, more downloading, more video chatting, and more cozy nights on the couch streaming your favorite movies and TV shows. If life with double the speed is sounding pretty awesome, that's because it is. It's time to get more out of your internet with faster speeds from Xfinity. Get 150 megabit Xfinity internet for only $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. That's double the speed for the same great price. Plus, for a limited time, learn how you can get a $100 prepaid card when you get more speed when you sign up online. Just go to Xfinity.com to switch today. Requires paperless billing and autopay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Equipment taxes and other charges extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and not guaranteed.
Man, I'm telling you, the difference it makes when you switch out your windows and doors. I did it, and it took me 3 years to do it because I paid it off in phases. BNT will work with you, just like they worked with me. If you don't have all the money up front, you can break it up into three phases like I did. And now, bam, here I am. Last year was my first hurricane season with my house completely fortified courtesy of BNT Windows and Doors. Every window, every door, hurricane ready. It just gave me a sense of peace I had never had before. I gotta tell you, it was kind of nice to be like, well, I've done everything I can to fortify this home. Whatever happens, happens. It did give me peace. You want that peace too. Get it for yourself. Call BNT. You know, they use custom PGT products, and PGT makes the best-selling window and door on the market. Go online today. BNT Windows and Doors.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
Starting with one store in 1978, Boot Barn has become the largest Western and workwear retailer in the nation. Supporting those who feed, build, and protect America, we offer the largest selection of cowboy boots, work boots, Western wear, workwear, and outdoor gear. With over 500,000 pairs of boots and thousands of top quality jeans and clothing, it's an honor to support the people who make our country so great. Boot Barn. Keep West.
Did you know that you can travel in the I-95 express lanes for free? With this program from the Florida Department of Transportation, you can carpool with two or more other people and ride the I-95 express lanes for free. Your smarter commute starts at carpoolmiami.com.
Presented by Lemes RV in Port St. Lucie and Davie.
RV Show USA comes to the Climate Controlled Expo Halls at South Florida Fairgrounds. Hundreds of new and used RVs are priced for immediate sale. Enjoy massive discounts on top names like Tiffin, Winnebago, Fleetwood, Thor, Integra, and more.
Plus a great selection of discounted used RVs to choose from.
Free parking and admission. For more information, see RVShowUSA.com. RV Show USA, inside at South Florida Fairgrounds in West Palm Beach, starts Thursday.
Fourth annual Jupiter Irish Fest is happening on Saturday, March 9th and 10th. Wear your green and bring your entire family out to Abacawa Amphitheater to celebrate the Irish culture. Enjoy authentic Irish food, learn how to pull your own pint of Guinness, and sip on the finest Irish whiskies. You'll be able to listen to live Irish music on the Slane Castle stage, enter the costume contest, and much more. Get your tickets today at jupiteririshfest.com. General admission is $5. Children 12 and under are free. See you all on March 9th and 10th at the Jupiter Irish Festival.
Well, anti-aging is certainly one of my favorite games to play. And at Begin Anew, they play it so well. They have everything under the sun when it comes to anti-aging. Of course, that total optimal wellness check where you can look at your blood work and you can see everything. Hormones, nutrients, vitamin deficiencies, food sensitivities, all the things that are affecting you and how you feel are in your blood work. And you can optimize how you feel. It really is amazing. Begin Anew. They've also got the semaglutide if you're looking to lose the weight. That works. I'm telling you, people are losing like 30, 40, 50, 60 pounds, and it is quick. It is amazing. It is life-changing. Drop my name at Begin Anew and get $75 off the cost of your treatment. They've also got estheticians and dermaplaning and facials and all kinds of fun stuff to make your skin look and feel amazing. Go to beginanewmed.com and then see them in Jupiter. Beginanewmed.com.
Injured in an accident? Visit Lytle Rider Smith Ivy and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, coming up in your dirt, we had told you last week that Don Henley had this whole case, and he was trying to come after these three guys for stealing the lyrics to Hotel California, and they were in court yesterday. It was so dramatic. And then the trial ended early. What happened? Who did what? I'll tell you coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Who wants to laugh their ass off? Ooh, I know I do. Ha, 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 ha. He wrote some funny punchlines just for me and you. It's Danny's Joke Jury.
Who's ready to laugh?
Ah, here we go. Danny's got the comedy. We're going to tell him what is working and what is not on the joke jury. What do you got for us today, Denny's?
All righty. Why was Jack Hanna standoffish with Jane Goodall?
Jack Hanna standoffish with Jane Goodall. I don't know why.
Because she had a chimp on her shoulder.
Yes,
that's
she
a good
did.
Joke, man.
Yeah, she did. Monkeys love it.
Yeah.
Denny's is so good.
That's a great joke.
Second joke. What do you call a horse that doesn't believe in God?
I don't know. What do you call a horse that doesn't believe in God?
An atheist?
What? Love the animal.
Jen's been watching a lot of animal stuff. It clearly bleeds into my subconscious. Third joke. What exam do you have to pass to become a cocaine lawyer?
Cocaine lawyer. No, what kind of exam do you have to pass?
The Pablo Escobar.
Oh wow.
Yes. Smart comedy.
That's very smart. Well crafted. Yeah.
Elevated. Fourth joke. What channel can you watch the Origami Championship?
Boy, can you imagine watching that? I don't know. What channel is that on?
Pay-per-view.
Pay-per-view. I don't know if you got 18 hours of sleep or something.
Come on, man.
On fire.
Wow. Oh, my God.
This is Netflix special material.
This man is working.
All right. Final joke for you guys. Why did they blur out the bottom half of Clifford the Big Red Dog?
The bottom half? I don't know. Why'd they blur it out?
Because he had a mastiff erection.
That is good stuff. That's
you know we
round.
Love erection jokes.
Yeah, 5 for 5, man. 5 for 5.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, I think Don Henley and his lawyer thought they were going to be slippery and better than the people that they were going up against in court and better than the judicial system. This is kind of a weird case. So there's three guys that Don Henley is accusing of scheming to steal the lyrics to the iconic Hotel California song by the Eagles. So Don Henley is suing these three guys.
And by the way, Don Henley loves a lawsuit. He don't,
does he?
I'm telling you,
it's
man.
It's not his first rodeo.
Don't mess with the Eagles. In fact, he might sue us for saying their name on the air.
Well, he thought, I guess, he was so slick. Him and his lawyer decided to not turn over about 6,000 pages of key evidence that made a big difference in the trial. And so they kept citing attorney-client privilege. And what the judge said is, no, 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 no. You have to, in discovery, show the other side what you're going to be presenting as your evidence so they have a chance to cross-examine based on that information. There was key evidence that they held back.
They tried to do a switcheroo,
like a sneaky move.
A wrestler coming back that's been on vacation for 4 months. And, oh, my gosh. But yeah, and you have to let everyone know everything.
You can't do that. And the judge was like, all right, mistrial. Because you can't do that. And so I don't know what's going to happen now. I guess they're going to have to regroup and put it all back together again and try this lawsuit.
But I'm a big, big Eagles fan, but I'm not a huge fan of Don Henley. Or I wasn't a huge fan of Glenn Frey either, as far as just them.
Yeah, it sounds like he thought he was smarter than the court and was going to try to do this move. And the judge is like, no, you can't do that.
They kind of came off a little pompous to me. And
yes.
Very arrogant. And like, dude, we get it. You guys write great songs. You're awesome.
Just because you're Don Henley, it doesn't mean you can hold back key evidence till midway through the trial and then go,
right.
Huzzah.
That's not how it works.
I like the other guys in the band, and they, you know, you don't know because you weren't there.
Nobody knows the other guys in the band.
But that's just it. I've seen the specials. I've seen them in interviews. And the whole kind of thing is Don and Glenn ran the band, and they were kind of not easy to work with.
Interesting. Well, this guy has to be super happy that he's got a new gig. He did get a huge payday, finally. The Bachelor had to pay Chris Harrison to fire him, which has got to be the sweetest deal ever.
Right.
That's awesome. But, you know, he hasn't really worked since The Bachelor and just made the big announcement yesterday. Chris Harrison, former host of The Bachelor, is going to be teaming up with Dr. Phil. And he is going to be doing a reality dating series and be the co-host of a television morning show with Dr. Phil, created by Dr. Phil.
I can't believe it! Dr. Wow. Phil and Nancy Grace sound identical!
Only thing difference is the boobies.
They're pretty much the same person, too.
They kind of are, just different gender.
You're absolutely
They're
right.
They're the same human, wow. Maybe, is Nancy Grace Dr. Phil in drag?
I don't know, but I just know that they are very similar.
I think we just uncovered something, Jay Bird. And finally here, I know this is very 70s music heavy. I apologize. Going from the Eagles to the Doobie Brothers.
I'm loving it.
I knew you would like it. And this is kind of for you. Guess who's getting back together?
Tell me it's Michael McDonald.
You are right, sir.
Yeah.
It's Michael McDonald and the Doobie Brothers. They haven't really played together. Now, they did one-offs here and there.
They did a version of a couple of their songs during COVID, and without Michael McDonald, they sounded freaking awesome. They're obviously all older now. They were some old-time rockers still nailing it, sounding awesome.
If you've got beef in your band and you're young rockers, you stay separate corners. But I think when you get older and the testosterone diminishes and the money diminishes, you go, whatever beef we had back in the 70s and 80s, let's put that aside.
I can tell you this, Michael McDonald does not need money. He's legendary. These guys.
I know, but I mean, when you think about how much money is going to be on the line here for these two to get back together, I mean, the Doobie Brothers and Michael McDonald reuniting—that's huge.
And I'm not sure they had beef either.
Oh, they didn't.
I'm not sure. Yeah, it's a very old dirt. People are probably bored, and I appreciate it. Thank you.
I did it for you.
And we lost some ratings.
That's what's going on in your disappointing dirt.
It's time for viral audio.
Hey, yeah, beautiful hair.
They can't hear me because they're listening to Kids Bop.
We got wings and dick.
There we go.
Got lots of tears going on here. Oh, boy, did you see how GMA was selling this Gisele Bündchen interview that she's doing, talking about Tom Brady?
It's exactly everything I told you it was 2 years ago. Tom Brady broke a promise to Gisele, and she said, okay, you're not going to retire. I'm done.
Oh, people are going to lose their minds over this interview.
So highly emotional.
Everything I've experienced, it made me realize what I want and what I don't want.
You didn't think that the marriage would end. No one goes into a marriage thinking it's going to end, but it does. You said it was the death of a dream.
Yeah.
How are you?
Well, when you say... Sorry, guys. I didn't know... Can I have a little moment?
Oh, my goodness.
She's trying to sack the goat.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, she's gonna Britney Spears Timberlake his ass.
Yeah.
Oh,
and I am here for it.
Oh, yeah.
Take that man down, girl.
Whoever cut that promo knew what they were doing. Dramatic music, the pause.
Yeah. Oh,
tell
man.
It all, girl. Tell them
boy.
He promised you he was gonna retire, then he came out of retirement, turned his back on his family. Tell them, girl.
Look, you're going after the goat. He ain't gonna take this lightly. Yeah. His team is working on this one.
Whatever.
He's going to do his own interview on the beach like he did when he was retiring.
Jesus is on her side.
Oh, is she big?
I don't know, but I'm telling you, Jesus is on her side.
What does that
mean? That
means that she's on the right side of history. Her man broke a promise to her, and that's when their marriage crumbled.
I can't do this debate with Virginia again.
I know, because she has no proof, no bearing, no understanding.
Virginia's
She's
a real-life troll, like an internet troll, but on the microphone. She just says comments, then backs away, and just lets me and you have to deal with the explosion. Does it in meetings, too.
Suck it.
A lot more emotion, too, on the New Heights podcast with Travis and Jason Kelce. If you saw Jason Kelce retiring from the NFL the other day.
Oh, it was such a great retirement speech, Kevin.
And then he worked in a nice moment about his wife.
He plugged his podcast.
Talking about meeting her. I mean, just doing it right.
And so good.
So here they are on the podcast talking about the retirement announcement. Here's his brother, Travis, talking about his experience with it.
You've always been a step ahead of me
I'm older, Trey.
In this game. To have you out of it, man, it feels empty. It feels like it's complete. It was a success.
Aww.
It was a fun journey to watch. And, and like I said yesterday, man, I just appreciate you showing me the way and bringing us all along the journey with you, big guy. It was cool being the tag team of the National Football League. Pretty cool.
Wow.
Oh, that makes me cry. It's so good, Kevin.
It was so good. Honestly, it is so good. They are looking at striking a $100 million deal for that podcast.
Yeah, no, I mean, look.
They're saying Jason Kelce on the market is probably going to command more money than Bill Belichick, the greatest coach of all time.
Jason Kelce is the verbal star out of the Kelce boys.
What's up with
he is so good on the mic.
What's up with all these Jasons crying on the microphone?
That's what Jason means. It's it means pansy.
If you look it up in the dictionary, it says bitch ass.
No, I know. I didn't. Every time I go on our YouTube to upload something, the first video that always pops up, Jay Bird cries to the new Billy Joel song. I'm like, this is the one that comes up every time?
It went viral of how much of a girl you are.
Jason Kelce went from crying on the podcast to going out and making good on that bet with the Buffalo Bills fans. He jumped through a flaming table.
Ooh, can we recreate that?
That's what the Bills do. It's amazing. They have those folding tables. They light them on fire. And then some Bills fan stands up on his truck bed and leaps in the air and then crashes onto the table.
Yeah.
Coach,
Panda's done it.
I want to do it. Can we do it?
Yeah, it's good for everybody who has really bad backs.
I know.
Don't you have a terrible back?
A horrible hamstring, but the spirit, baby, in my prime. I want it. I want the fight.
You do? Okay.
Sometimes an injury is good for a man.
Yeah.
You've been limping around these halls for the past week.
Sometimes it doesn't feel right when I'm not limping.
What if you went through the table and then the limping stopped?
That would probably happen.
Travis Kelce went on to talk about how he's heading to Singapore to hang out with Taylor Swift, his girlfriend.
Making all the right moves, Kevin. Yeah. These guys cannot lose right now.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, this is the part where everyone likes you. Oh, but the fall, baby. The fall.
Q score on point. Cash in.
Yeah. Nothing great lasts forever.
That's why you got to cash in now before everything turns.
Well, you know how it is. Everyone loves you, and then people, they'll get so big to where people turn.
Something will happen. They'll accidentally say something.
They're on the climb right now.
Exactly.
Cash it in now, boys.
And delete old tweets. Let's look back at those.
Justin Timberlake did the blind karaoke challenge where somebody brings up the karaoke version of a song on their computer, and then you got to try to figure out what the song is and sing it without the lyrics.
That's fun.
That is fun.
Oh, blind karaoke.
Yeah, they tried it with Radiohead's Creep.
What's the opening line? Can't look you in the eye, just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry.
That's fun.
We do deaf karaoke, so blind karaoke is kind of fun.
That is fun, and man, I do love that song. I know they hate the song Radiohead. That song still great hits song. For me.
That song is a banger.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Well, we got our own headphone karaoke coming up here in about 15 minutes. You'll get to hear Virginia and Jaybird singing today. Also got a makeup or breakup email or two. This person wanted to know, my husband's peculiar photo hobby might ruin our marriage. You'll find out why next.
If they saw what I saw, they would fall the way I fell. But they don't know what you want. And baby, I would never tell. If they knew what I know, they would never let you go. So guess what? So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it when you're out looking like you do. But you can't hide it, no. Put you in a frame, oh baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made every time the phone rings, I hope that it's you on the other side. I wanna tell you everything, everything that's on my mind. And I don't want any other guys taking my place, girl. I got too much pride. I know I may be wrong, but I don't wanna be right. Cause your lips were made for mine, and my heart would go flatline if it wasn't beating for you all the time. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it when you're out looking like you do. But you can't hide it, no. Put you in a frame, oh baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. So if I get jealous, you must be an angel.
help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish.
What do you think? Is this a makeup or a breakup? A lot of people just have problems in the relationships. I don't know if you know this. But when you're trying to think, maybe I need to get out of this relationship, you just send us an email. We'll give you our thoughts on it. Mail at kvjshow.com. Since I was at the pool with my husband, I had been taking a nap. I did wake up, start to open my eyes, and I see my husband. He's on his phone. It looks like he's trying to take a photo. So I look around, and when I focus, I see there are two teenage girls in bikinis in his path. I then fully wake up, and I say, "What are you doing?" He kind of jumps up and gets all defensive, like I've caught him doing something he shouldn't.
Oh, no.
He then starts playing it off like, nothing, I'm not doing anything. We start fighting right there at the pool. We then start to leave the pool because of the fight, and I say, "I need to see your phone." He's like, "I'm not giving you my phone." I'm like, "You give me my phone. You give me your phone, or you're not sleeping in this house tonight."
I agree with that.
Well, you caught him. You caught him doing something unsavory.
Being a pervert.
So when I go into his phone, I find a lengthy library of teenage girls in bikinis. Most of them, I would assume, are over 16, I would guess. But a few, I would say, could be in their younger teens. I ask him what the hell he is doing with these photos. He tells me he has a photo hobby.
Oh, you're a photographer now?
They go film a tree.
I tell him BS. I make him leave our house to give me time to think. So he goes to his sister's house, and now we're a few days in on this, and I just don't know where to go with it. We've been married for 10 years, and we're in our late 30s. Thankfully, we don't have any children of our own, but I can only imagine how I would feel if we did. Is he a predator? I mean, is this not as bad as I'm making it? Do you go to therapy for something like this, or do you end a marriage right away? My emotions are all over the place, and I need some perspective. What is my next move?
Honestly, man, I'm the wrong person to ask this, because to me, this is such a divorce situation. You're with a guy that's he's clearly doing something unsavory, and then he's lying to you on top of it.
You need to really take him and his stupidness out of the equation. Can you get over this, or are you going to think about this all the time? If this was me, I would think about this all the time. This is a character flaw of a man who's into underage girls and was so stupid that he got caught taking a picture of them by the pool. Do you like him? Do you like him or not? Because if you don't like him now with this new information, maybe you didn't like him before now. This is a good out for you.
There are some things in life where you don't even want to try to work through. It just, your spirit is done with it. It's a deal breaker to your spirit. And I know they say you got to try to fight for your marriage and all this stuff.
No, you don't.
For me, this is a deal breaker, because it's so, you're going to lay in bed with this guy, and this is never going to get out of your head.
You're
going to
think about, if you're like me, and you are over-analyzing and over-paranoid about everything, you're going to think about this. And like Jay Bird said, yeah, you're going to be laying in bed at night thinking about, is he thinking about teenage girls? Is that how you want to live the rest of your life? It's not about him. It's about you.
Is anybody defending the husband at all in the chat or in the... Is anyone going, guys, you guys sound like snowflakes?
I am seeing a point to discuss and debate. Julia said, this is more than divorce. That's a crime. Now, my question is that a crime? These are teenage girls that are in public. It is way ick, very creepy. I'm suspect that he may have things that are illegal in his possession, but if you took a photo of a teenage girl in a bikini in public at a pool, is that a crime?
Not a crime. It's not.
Not a crime, but a very big ick.
And that's one of them things where, that's why we always joke about stalkers and creepy people have so many rights. You're allowed to be creepy, man. Well, the law allows it.
Yeah, and Carolina in the chat, she said, you got to report this to the police. What do the police do?
They're going to probably be like, I don't know what to tell you.
You don't have to report this to the police. What you do have to go do, though, is look on your computer, look on your hard drive, do a little due diligence before you break up with this man and make sure that he's not got like kiddie porn or weird stuff on your computers or any of your devices or any of that. Because if he does, then you do have to take this and turn it in.
I'm glad that we are having this discussion, because just that, what that comment just said, you got to report this to police. So me being one of the people, when we've had this conversation before, I thought, you did have rights out in public. You don't. When you go outside right. of your sure. house, yeah. they can film whatever they can. Now, they can't go inside your house, do anything. Yeah. But just know
you
when
step
you
step outside those doors, it's open season.
Everything's mm-hmm. being filmed, and the police are now getting very, very savvy to all this. They're going to tell you immediately, there's nothing we can do
You're
about it.
You're in public, you can be filmed.
No, you can't go up and harass somebody. That's harassment.
Right. But he wasn't harassing.
He wasn't harassing.
He was sneakily being a pervert and taking pictures of young girls at a public venue. It's not illegal.
For a lot of people, this is going to be a tough one to get over, I think.
Crystal said, what if you did have daughters? You know, what if your daughter's teenage friends come over and they go swimming or something? And we just had that story the last couple of days in the Whacked Out News about the dad in Oregon that benzoed the mango smoothies he made for his 12-year-old daughter's friends. And he had them doing some creepy things like hopping in a hot tub and showering afterwards. And this might be that same kind of guy. And yeah, not illegal, but I'm right there with you. I think this is a massive character flaw. This is an issue. It comes off shady. I'm going deal breaker on it, too. I would not let him back in the house for a good while.
And it's not about him. It's about you.
Absolutely.
You yeah. need to protect your own sanity. You don't want to spend the rest of your life worried that you're married to a pedophile.
Which is,
yeah.
once it's in your brain, you can't erase what's in there about him. And he's not the man you thought he was. It's okay for you to walk away.
And just know if someone's filming you, they're allowed to do it. It sucks. I get it. I get it. Remember when I talked about that old guy? He was having a moment out in public. He was eating dinner by himself, and he brought a picture of his wife, his deceased wife, and he was having this moment. Someone filmed him secretly and then posted it on TikTok. I was against it, saying, this guy's having a moment. He doesn't want to be all over social media. I got slammed on that going, yeah. Bird, out in public?
You're wrong.
He shouldn't have done that out in public then.
Everybody yeah. is entitled to film you in public. If you're in public and they're in public, you can't say squat. Yeah.
You had the story of the guy filming the little girl's dancing. He was filming her butt. The police checked it out. Mm. She was dancing. He was filming her butt. They let him go.
Yeah, yeah. There's not a lot you knew, but it does reveal to you a serious character issue with your husband, and it sounds like getting away from him is the best move. And I can understand why you're torn and twisted by this.
And don't be tricked by people that tell you, oh, you got to go to therapy. Oh, you got to try to work through it with him. Are you able to, and you know in your mind, are you able to forget this? And if you're like me and you're not, bye.
I'm Italian. We don't forget a lot of things. In fact,
can't.
My mom would rattle off these stats my dad did. 1983, you came home at 7-Eleven, and you were drunk. I'm like, what?
Well, it's real.
If you got your own issue, you can always send us an email, mail@kvjshow.com for makeup or breakup. We got a little bit of singing coming up. Headphone karaoke is on the way. You put on the headphones, blast the audio. We only hear your a cappella version. It is a head-to-head with Virginia and Jaybird coming up next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Still seeing fairly heavy delays this morning following this earlier accident on 95 southbound at the exit for 6th Avenue South. Look for a left lane blocked in that area. As for the turnpike, no major incidents reported right now, but you are under speed on the southbound side of the turnpike between Okeechobee Boulevard and Lake Worth Road, and you're also seeing some slowdowns in the area of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza on the northbound side. Plus, there's a crash tying you up on 95 southbound right at the exit for Bridge Road, this one blocking a left lane causing slowdowns. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Gotta admit, I probably watch about 4 or 5 different platforms now, easily. And if I didn't have my Xfinity Flex, my streaming 4K TV box, it would be really tough to go from one to the other, but I It's not a problem. All I do is I take the voice-controlled remote, I say it, and it plays it. It can jump around from my Netflix over to my Amazon Prime, whatever it is. It can get me there into the show I want right away. And you can get it with Xfinity Internet, which, by the way, is awesome, super fast, and reliable, and it comes with 20 million Wi-Fi hotspots all over America. And let me tell you, too, the Xfinity Flex 4K streaming box, it's an easy setup. You just plug it in, connect it right to your Xfinity Internet, you start streaming in second. You get your TV, your movies, your documentaries, your live sports. It is all there, and all you have to do is go to Xfinity.com or call 1-800-XFINITY. Xfinity Flex is available to Xfinity Internet customers, excluding Internet. Essentials and prepaid customers who do not have Xfinity TV, one-time $15 activation fee per account, limited to 3 devices. Currently, one device included with monthly Xfinity Internet service. Additional devices, $5 a month.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose 2 of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious small fries for only $3.89. Now, my day is made. The tastiest way, when I bundle and save at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid when product served.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is, but the rest of your body, oh yes, it's gonna relish every moment of it, because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
We are proud of our parents.
Want to know why?
Because they work for the school district of Palm Beach County.
There's lots of great jobs.
With paid vacation, holidays off, health care, and retirement.
You can be on the same schedule as your kids.
Come work at the school district of Palm Beach County.
You'll see why it's your best choice.
Join us at the Team Palm Beach Schools Job Fair. Register at palmbeachschools.org/jobfair. That's palmbeachschools.org/jobfair.
Once you meet Dr. Rankin face to face and you see the way he is, his Zen personality, his amazing, healing, talented, gifted surgical hands, you're like, okay, this guy knows what he's doing. And at the Aquaplastic Surgery Center, Dr. Rankin runs the show. He has put together the team. It's he, Dr. Bauermeister, and the female plastic surgeon, Dr. Giselle. They listen and they care. They want you to feel your best and live your best. They know that you being safe in their hands is so important. They make sure that every patient feels safe and that they listen and care about their patients. If you're thinking about anything body, these are the body experts. Liposuction, mommy makeovers, breast lifts, breast explanting. Go see the pros in Jupiter or in Boca. Aquaplasticsurgery.com.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex.
But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Starting off with some patchy fog this morning, but that'll burn away this afternoon. For today, 80 degrees, we're partly sunny. Could pick up a shower or a storm, mainly into Palm Beach County. Into the Treasure Coast, we're generally dry. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Today, we're the largest injury firm in the world, and I'm thankful to you for trusting us all these years. We'll always be here for the people, not the powerful. We'll always be here for you. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Experience the Anajar & Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
But one thing I always love doing is checking out what is going on in the whacked out news. And we have got some pretty crazy stories. One, Virginia's talking about Dollar General, I believe, and some of the benefits of it.
She was.
Got a story that might make you rethink your Dollar General shopping coming up here in your whacked out news.
Oh, just no. Let you know. I told you, don't get food from there.
Yeah. Okay.
But paper products I like to save.
That's always a good thing to say about a place. When you go there, do not eat the food.
Yeah. Also, we got some cops behaving badly right here in South Florida. I'll let you know exactly what they have been doing as well. So there's a lot of stuff you do not want to miss coming up here in about the next 10 minutes. Right now, we've got some headphone karaoke. What we do is our two competitors are going to be strapping on headphones, blasting really loud music. The song that they are singing, they can hear in their headphones. You cannot. You only get their a cappella performance. Virginia and Jaybird are going head-to-head today. So we're going to find out what song they're going to sing, and then you're going to get to vote on who does the worst performance.
I picked mine. I haven't looked at it yet, Virginia. You want to pick yours? Is that how we do it? Am I messing up the bit?
Go right ahead. What song do you have, Bird?
I have...
You can't read through those pizza glasses?
I can't read through these glasses, and I also am losing my eyesight, so it's very tough. Kelly Clarkson, Since You've Been Gone. Ooh.
That's, okay.
Ugh.
Since You've Been Gone. What did you get, call Virginia?
Can I be Belly Clarkson?
Mm-hmm. I got Summer Nights.
Oh, okay. Summer Lovin'.
Had me blessed.
Okay.
Summer Lovin'. Ooh. Happened so fast.
Just give me my shot. I'm going to lose. Kelly Clarkson, dog. It's so high.
Okay. We'll hand the headphones whoever you want, Denny. See, is. Strap them on whoever needs to go right now.
Age before beauty. You go first, Pumpkin.
Okay.
I picked first. You go first.
Dude. Okay, Virginia, you sing first.
Kevin's got to tell us what to do. Yeah, otherwise, we'll just fight for the next 7 minutes.
Okay, so Virginia's going to be doing Summer Lovin' here. Okay. It's going to be like a good 30-second rendition here. Headphones are on. She'll be hearing the song. We'll only hear her lovely voice.
Hold on.
Okay, you all set there, Virginia?
Yeah.
Okay, a little summer loving. Okay.
Summer fun, something's begun, but the summer nights. Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well, oh, tell me more, tell me more. Tell me more, tell me more. Did she put up a fight? Ba, wa, wa, ba, wa, wa, ba, ba, wa, wa, ba, ba,
What was that?
It's almost like she did her own version of...
You sounded like seven different Muppets that I've never heard of. But
but nailed it.
Hey, we're having fun, aren't we?
Okay. Oh, gosh. That happened fast.
We still might win.
I don't know. No.
Okay, Bird, you got some Kelly Clarkson since you've been gone. Let's see if you can perform better than Virginia.
All right, here it goes.
You've been gone. I can't breathe for the first time. I'm moving on. Yeah, yeah. This is you. Next I want, I can't read the words. My eyesight is gone.
Since you've been gone.
Is that what you're singing
read.
About? Is your eyesight?
He's singing to his eye.
He's singing to his eye. Since you've been gone. Blur. I cannot see for the first time.
Damn.
That works out.
Oh, you need to get some readers.
I know. I asked my doctor about it. They told me to go to the eye doctor.
Yeah, like, we're not that kind of doctor.
They broke that down to me.
We do butt stuff here.
All right, the voting begins now. Okay.
Oof.
Who do you think did the worst performance? If you are watching us on YouTube on KVJ TV, let us know right now. Who did worse, Virginia or Jay Bird? The loser drinks a You Suck shot. Coming up after Olivia Rodrigo's Vampire on the KVJ show.
I hate to give the satisfaction asking how you're doing now. How's the castle built off people you pretend to care about? Just what you wanted. Look at you, cool guy, you got it. I see the parties in diamonds. Sometimes when I close my eyes, 6 months of torture you sold to some forbidden paradise. I loved you truly. You gotta laugh at the stupidity. 'Cause I've made some real big mistakes, but you make the worst one look fine. I should've known it was strange. You only come out at night. I used to think I was smart, but you made me look so nice. Bleed me dry like a damn vampire. And every girl I ever talked to told me you were bad, bad news. You called them crazy. God, I hate the way I called them crazy too. You're so convincing. How do you lie without flinching? Ooh, what a mesmerizing, paralyzing, tragic little thrill. Can't figure out just how you do it, and God knows I never will. Girls your age know better. I've made some real big mistakes, but you make the worst one look fine. I should have known it was strange. You only come out at night. I used to think I was smart, but you made me look so naive. The way you saw me for parts as you sunk your teeth into me. Dry like a damn vampire. You said it was true love, but wouldn't that be hard? You can't love anyone, 'cause that would mean you had a heart. I tried to help you out, now I know that I can't. 'Cause how you think's the kind of thing I'll never understand. I made some real big mistakes, but you make the worst one look fine. I should've known it was strange. You only come out at night. I used to think I was smart, but you made me look so naive. The way you saw me for parts as you sunk your teeth into me. I'm a light sucker, dream crusher, bleeding me dry like a damn vampire.
And the crowd was going crazy.
You betrayed! I'm gonna
Young girls in there, a lot of energy.
Look, she's got passion, yeah. And she plays her own instrument.
She's a great talent.
I like that Vampire song.
Yeah. Look, I'm a big fan of Get Back That Man That Hurt You.
Okay.
She's getting it.
Yeah. She's very talented.
You know my friend, Gender Warsenicki.
Get it, Olivia. Get it.
All right, well, we did some headphone karaoke a second ago. Virginia had on the headphones. She was singing Summer Nights.
And pissing off our male fan base right before voting. Yeah. What are you doing?
May not be the right play. Yeah. Here was her singing a second ago.
Okay, summer fun, something's begun, but the summer nights. Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well, oh, tell me more, tell me more. Tell me more, tell me more. Did she put up a fight?
Okay, all right.
I have an aunt up in Rhode Island that sounds just like that. And it's a lot.
Mm-hmm. And it's a lot. That song is a lot. You love that song.
I love.
We should have switched.
I know. I was kind of torn. Yeah.
And Jaber did Kelly Clarkson, Since You've Been Gone.
You've been gone. I can't breathe for the first time. I'm moving on. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And I dropped down to like 90s.
Yeah.
I should have sang the whole thing like that.
Since you've been gone. So who did worse according to the voting? 63% of people said it was Virginia.
So close.
I knew it.
Yeah. Rats. And that means I have to make her...
The You Suck Shot.
Kevin, this one's kind of exciting for me to do.
Okay.
Because we know our girl. She doesn't really love blue.
Okay, so you got a half a cup of water there.
Oh, you douche.
Oh,
that's not a shot, by the way. It's like huge.
Uh-huh. There you go.
Okay.
Kevin, there we go. All right. So she hates blue anything. I mean... It really does bother her. I've seen her yell at her kid for eating blue anything.
Well, she thinks that when you get the blue dye on your lips, it looks like you're dead, and that freaks her out. So she's going to have blue dye all over her lips.
Oh,
she's going to look like she's dead. It's going to freak herself out.
Virginia's got beautiful white teeth.
Yeah. I do not have butter cutters.
But not for long.
They're about to be smurfy.
And if you are new to our program, you're probably listening going, blue dye? This is so not a punishment. This is how you get the witch finally.
Okay.
You finally get her with this.
So she's got water with blue food dye. Virginia, is that what we got for the You Suck Shot?
Do we want to add anything? I mean, the blue dye is almost insulting enough.
Let's just see how it looks.
Because you know what? We try to make her... Grossed out. We can't gross her out.
I'm so mad
right now. She's mad.
Because I saw you come in with all this other stuff, and I was like, okay, I can handle all that. And then you pulled out the blue dye.
Just in case I, squeaked by and won this one, it's a blue dye ready to go.
And you call yourself a friend.
Coworker first. It's all about them ratings.
Half cup. Knock her down, Virginia, and once you smile into the camera.
You got to.
You are such a D-bag.
Hold on. By the way, I'm throwing Denny's under the bus. This was his idea.
Denny's! Yeah. Ah! Two Denny's?
Oh, it was my idea. Never mind.
Whoa.
You almost had me crucify Denny's on the radio?
He brought it in. My bad.
You told him to bring it in. He just did your marching orders.
I found the item.
Okay.
But it was Jaybird's idea.
He wanted you to drink it.
All right. Enough of your belly aching.
No.
Give us a swish, too.
Oh, I can't wait to get you back.
I'm
going to hurt you.
Whatever.
It's going to be physical.
I've eaten a Band-Aid. I've eaten a baby sock. Yeah. Bring it on. I am numb.
That is nothing compared to what I am going to do for you.
Not scared in the least, but it makes me excited.
You should be living in fear. Every move you make, I will be around some corner.
Kevin's going to punch you or me if we don't get this bit over with. Drew Barrymore?
Except I don't know if she likes it.
This is awesome. And I can't find my phone. I want to film this.
Okay, here we go. All right, Virginia, down the hatch with your You Suck Shot. Let's see what you got here.
Mad at you.
Swish it, baby.
You are the...
Wow.
I know!
The dramatics.
All right. All right. All right! You are such a D.
It's a big old cup of water. Blue food dye. Get it all down. Get it all down. There you go.
Swish it around.
Okay. Let's see.
No. Smile.
Okay. Let's see what you
there
got.
There we go.
Blue
yes.
teeth. Yeah. Just what she loves. Very nice. Okay. Paying that off. Okay.
That, Kevin, that's so... Stop.
Yeah. I know, huh? And she spit water on you.
The good thing is it's on my computer now.
Yeah. Boy, that poor computer's had a week, hasn't it?
Ow! There's a lot of dumbass criminals to talk about, baby. It's the whacked out news. People breaking the law. Ha ha, fighting in the nude. Ha, drunk people pooping in the street. Ha ha, it's the whacked out news. So many people are meth. Ow!
Well, we got a lot of cops behaving badly here today in your whacked out news, including one from Indian River County. The deputy was spending his first day on the job when he decided to ask a female high school student for nude photos. You can't do that.
First day?
First day.
Oh, dude.
On the job as a cop for Indian River County Sheriff's Office, and he asked a female high school student for nudes. Kai Stewart Cromer of Vero Beach. He apparently tried to get some nude photos, was busted, and was arrested.
Did he do this on body cam?
I'm not sure how they got the evidence, what's going on in the case, but apparently he contacted other victims using Snapchat, so there's a nice paper trail.
Dude, that's there was another...
Or digital print.
There was another cop they got who was on Snapchat, and he thought that... It deletes. It's never to be found again. Like, dude, it never deletes.
That digital footprint's always going to be there. Yeah, congratulations. Another dumb cop happened in Miami-Dade. This guy's been on the force for 20 years when he decided to get all hammered and drive around in his car and then crashed into another officer all drunk. This happened on Southwest 72nd Street. He hit the police officer. And then he comes out of his vehicle and draws his weapon while intoxicated.
He drew his weapon drunk?
Yes, he did.
He hit the other guy. It was his fault. And then he wants to turn it into a gun battle?
Then he refused a sobriety test, and they put him in the back of the vehicle to take him in, and he peed all over himself.
Oh,
he had a bad night.
No.
Bad game.
Yes.
Dude, you've destroyed your career.
20 years on the force.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow, huh?
I wonder what he was drinking.
That's a great question. Something pretty strong. 70-year-old Alan Berinsky of Miami told police he was just trying to flirt with another traveler when he made a wisecrack about having a bomb in his bag at Fort Lauderdale Hollywood International Airport.
They don't like that kind of comedy.
Yeah, he said he was just trying to be funny. He was sitting there at gate G11 in Terminal 4 when two witnesses overheard him tell another passenger something like, yeah, you know, if the bomb in my bag goes off prematurely, I apologize to your family in advance. The two witnesses then became alarmed, reported his comments to police. They then stopped him and arrested him and charged him with making a false bomb report, which is a second-degree felony.
Did you see his mugshot?
Yeah, I did.
He's not cute. He looks deranged. He's got crazy face. When you see somebody like that sit next to you on the plane,
yeah. You
should probably try to move your seat.
What if it's your relative? You kind of have to fly with them.
Yeah. A Florida man took a locomotive for an unauthorized joyride. The vehicle was parked in the Florida Central Railroad train yard just south of Orlando. He apparently crawled in a window and got access, then managed to start a locomotive and took it on a 7-mile excursion, causing significant damage before abandoning it.
Oh, but those 7 miles, though.
Wow.
I mean, he had 7 miles of just pure joy. And he stole a train?
Stole a train.
Damn.
That whole 7 miles, is he thinking about...
Grand Theft Train.
Is he thinking about his out? That 7 miles he was going, is he going, all right, how am I going to get out of this thing?
He probably can't believe it. Be like, dude, I just stole a train.
And how do you know how to drive it?
I would imagine you go to jail for a long time for that, right?
It's kind of worth it.
They say he damaged a bunch of switches and controls, about $60,000 damage.
He just got in there and started pushing everything.
Yeah, I guess so. And it just started to move. He's like, all right, and
let's
away
go.
We go.
That's a great question. How hard is it to drive a train?
And how much time does he get? Because I think if you get like 6 weeks, it's worth it.
You think so, huh?
That is not a 6-week punishment.
Yeah. But the story, though.
Might be a little more.
Someone tells me he's going to be in cell block E.
Yeah. Well, check this out. There is a woman who is roaming the aisles of a Dollar Tree on Biscayne Boulevard in Miami Shores.
Okay. Dollar Tree is different from Dollar General.
Okay.
What's more low budget?
Dollar Tree.
Okay. But watch out, because apparently there was a guy who tapped her on the behind with the soda bottle.
Uh-oh.
And this guy was up to a bunch of no good.
Well, I was terrified and I was shocked because I have never experienced in my whole life.
In the middle of a store.
Exactly. The only thing that could come out of my head was like, okay, what are you doing? Please stop. I started kind of backing away from him slowly.
How long did he stand there like that?
It seemed like an eternity, but it could be more than a minute or so.
Just standing there with his...
Standing there, you know, pretending like nothing happened. There was another lady at the store who apparently had also an incident with that young man.
Incident. You think he's done this before?
For sure.
So with his what? What was that?
And also, can we maybe check out the guy interviewing? Yeah, tell me more. What were you wearing? Yeah.
He was so into it.
What kind of sounds did he make?
That
reporter sounded a little too eager.
Yeah.
Down boy.
Well, if you don't know, he was standing there fully exposing himself, just trying to get a rise out of the ladies at the Dollar Tree there in Miami Shores. He would tap and be like, hey, look at that, huh?
Whoa. Yeah, that's a move.
I bet you didn't bargain for this.
It's a thing.
Yeah.
It happened to my Aunt Anne at the Twin City Mall back in the day. She's walking to her car, and a guy was in his car, goes, hey, look at this, and shows it to her.
Showed it to her. Didn't tap her with
no,
it.
No, but he was doing things.
Oh, wow.
And we heard about that every Christmas.
Crazy video that happened from... February 18th, last month in Miami, video has captured this woman who is on a motor scooter at a red light shortly after 2 a.m. right there at Northwest 19th Avenue and Northwest 28th Street. She has a purse on her shoulder on the scooter. Car stops behind her. People come out, grab the purse off of her, rip her off the scooter. I think her pants came down or something because she's blurred out.
Oh, my God!
After that point. Got back in the car and took off in a silver Hyundai Elantra. Just ripped the purse right off her shoulder on her scooter. Threw it to the ground and then vroom, and away they went.
That is so brazen and horrifying.
Right. Just kind of a note, if you're ever on a scooter, first of all, don't be on a scooter at 2 a.m. in Miami. Like, that's not a good call.
True.
Yeah.
And maybe it was like a designer purse.
Yeah.
And they were like, oh, okay, this is going to be easy.
Yeah.
There's three of us, one of her, done.
Remember that game on January 2013 with the Dolphins and the Chiefs that was in Kansas City, and they talked about how the temperature was 4 below with a wind chill of minus 27?
It was so cold. People were, like, not able to move.
Yeah.
It was crazy. There's no way I would sit out there for that game.
Did you hear some people got frostbite?
I did.
Some of them are going to have to get body parts amputated.
All for a football game.
All for a football game. I'm like, is it worth it? You lost your pinky toe or your hand. Was it worth it for a football game?
There'll be some Chiefs fans that say, yes, it was worth it. And y'all crazy.
That is crazy. And is this crazy? Scientists, they say, have successfully reprogrammed elephant stem cells And they hope to be able to resurrect the woolly mammoth by 2028.
Okay, I'm like Drew Barrymore. Yes, I love it.
You get me excited when you start talking woolly mammoths,
baby.
Bird
is all in it. What do you think, woolly mammoths? Okay, there we go. Yes, they say they haven't seen a woolly mammoth in 4,000 years on planet Earth, so it could happen again.
Next up, T-Rex, baby. T-Rex.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Jurassic Park. On the way.
This is the dumbest thing I've heard all year.
Didn't we learn a lesson from like 8 movies?
Can't we just take these scientists and maybe put them on a worthwhile project? Like, I don't know, curing cancer? They're bringing back the woolly mammoth. This is dumber than dumb.
In the movie trailer, they go, sir, they're reproducing. It's just 9,000 mammoths stomping up to Washington.
Oh, my gosh. We have sunk to a new low.
All right, what do you think here? We got some real or fake Florida headlines for you. Is this real or fake? Florida woman calls for Sugar Daddy Appreciation Day at a board meeting. Real or fake? What does that feel like to you, Virginia?
That feels real. I think I saw the video.
Okay. Is your memory good enough? We'll find out coming up next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Speed slowly returning to normal after this earlier crash on 95 southbound in the area of 6th Avenue, but you can still expect to tap the brakes a little bit through that area. Turnpike also under speed right now in the area of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. Give yourself a little extra time there. Plus in Broward County, 95 northbound moving slowly right now between Cokens Road and Hillsboro Boulevard, and on the Turnpike northbound, you're under speed between the Coconut Creek Service Plaza and the Sawgrass Expressway. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer, and now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
Here at Massey, we've seen the damage termites can cause. That's why we've protected homes from termite damage for almost 100 years. Our termite protection program doesn't just protect your home from termites, it gives you peace of mind. That's why our termite protection guarantee covers your home and all the things in it. When we protect against termites, we protect families. Schedule your free inspection today at MasseyServices.com. Massey Services. Expect more and get it.
Man, I'm telling you, the difference it makes when you switch out your windows and doors. I did it, and it took me 3 years to do it because I paid it off in phases. BNT will work with you, just like they worked with me. If you don't have all the money up front, you can break it up into three phases like I did. And now, bam, here I am. Last year was my first hurricane season with my house completely fortified courtesy of BNT windows and doors. Every window, every door, hurricane ready. It just gave me a sense of peace I had never had before. I gotta tell you, it was kind of nice to be like, well, I've done everything I can to fortify this home. Whatever happens, happens. It did give me peace. You want that peace too. Get it for yourself. Call BNT. You know, they use custom PGT products, and PGT makes the best-selling window and door on the market. Go online today. BNT, windows and doors.com.
Tax Talk with Straight Talk.
You give and you give. This tax season you get with Straight Talk Wireless. You get a reliable 5G network and unlimited data and a new Samsung Galaxy A15 for just $99. So you can give your janky phone to your kid.
Yeah!
Good talk.
Switch to Straight Talk for plans starting as low as $25 a line per month for 4 lines. Find us at Walmart and StraightTalk.com. For network management practices, visit StraightTalk.com. Device offer ends 4/14/24. In-store activation on single Silver Unlimited plan or higher required. Family plan discount with 4 lines all on the Silver Unlimited plan. Taxes and fees apply.
Did you know Conky Joe's Seafood Restaurant and Bar has been one of the longest-standing waterfront establishments on the Treasure Coast? Guests have been laughing, making memories, and dining at the Jensen Beach Conky since 1983. Experience the essence of Martin County with Riverside Dining, renowned conch fritters, truly fresh fish, daily happy hour, live music, and Sunday brunch. Come to Conky Joe's to remember what you love about Jensen Beach, just north of the Jensen Beach Causeway. For reservations, visit ConkyJoe's.com or check out their Facebook page.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
I never wanted to get glasses, tried to do contact lenses, and it was a nightmare for me. I couldn't get them in my eyeballs every day. It was just a pain and an aggravation I didn't need. I never thought a LASIK procedure was something I could afford. I never thought it'd be something I could tolerate either. I figured it'd hurt. It doesn't. A laser does all the work. Your vision gets blurry. It clears up. You go back to work the very next day. It was that simple. 90 seconds, all it took. And it wasn't a pain in the pocket either. A lot more affordable than you'd ever think. It is going to save you money over time, so it's a great investment. Plus, they offer up a payment plan with zero down, zero interest for up to 12 months. And if you drop my name, Kevin from the KBJ Show, they'll take an additional $500 off at Panu Laser. So what are you waiting for? They have convenient locations all over Broward County, now in Palm Beach as well. And their Dr. Mutiella has performed over 100,000 of these LASIK procedures, so you're in the best hands possible. Book today at PanuLaser.com. That's P-A-N-N-U Laser.com.
Presented by Lemmings RV in Port St. Lucie and Davie.
RV Show USA comes to the Climate Controlled Expo Halls at South Florida Fairgrounds. Hundreds of new and used RVs are priced for immediate sale. Enjoy massive discounts on top names like Tiffin, Winnebago, Fleetwood, Thor, Integra, and more.
Plus a great selection of discounted used RVs to choose from.
Free parking and admission. For more information, see RVShowUSA.com. RV Show USA, inside at South Florida Fairgrounds in West Palm Beach, starts Thursday.
Wondering what to do with your tax refund? Call Strax Aesthetics for cosmetic surgery done right. Prices guaranteed to beat any quotes from board-certified surgeons. Strax will discount any quote by at least 10% for procedures performed by April 15, 2024. Lowest prices ever on gastric sleeves for massive weight loss. Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price on fillers and wrinkle reducers. All procedures are performed by renowned board-certified surgeons. Visit StraxPlastics.com for surgeon bios and to see great results. Call 954-749-3040 to schedule your free consultation. And take advantage of Strax's tax season special.
It is so important that you stay up with the maintenance of your AC. Do what I do. I'm in the cooling club and I get regular service and maintenance of my system courtesy of Cooling Advisors. They come out on a regular basis. They check the system. They do the tune-ups. They do the work. They do the line cleaning. They make sure that my system is functioning at its top peak level, saving me on energy costs. Yeah, that can save you like up to 30% a year on energy cost just by keeping up with the maintenance of your system. And when you keep up with your system, you get a longer life out of it, protecting your investment. I love the Cooling Club. You should call about it too. Go online, coolingadvisors.com. Over 70 years of experience, family owned and operated. They're not some big corporation from out of town. It's local guys, local families running this company, and they care about their reputation, so they get customer service right. Go to coolingadvisors.com.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider Smith, Ivy, and Fromrath at fouryearrights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Okay, can you tell which headlines are real and which ones are fake from our great state of Florida here? Jaybird has put these together, so he'll sit back and see how Virginia and Denny's does in this head-to-head competition, born right out of our whacked-out news. First one's for you, Virginia. Real or fake headline. Florida woman calls for Sugar Daddy Appreciation Day at board meeting. What do you think? Is that one going to be a real headline?
I saw that story, and I, too, am very pro Sugar Daddy Appreciation Day. So I believe in it. I believe in her. I believe in her platform. I think she should run for political office.
Okay. I mean, honestly, she might.
She should.
Yeah.
There's always goofy people running.
There's way worse. We've already elected.
Oh, someone's being political.
Phone calls, yep. Denny's.
Look out. Right.
Here, Suits, grab those.
I'm trying to kill Suits.
Yeah, make Suits answer the phones.
Get those calls, Suits.
All right, Virginia's going real. That is true. That is a real headline, yes.
Crazy, amazing. If you haven't seen that video, go look it up.
But are we really appreciating our sugar daddies here in the state? Maybe not.
Maybe not enough.
Absolutely.
No, we don't appreciate it because they're coming from New York and taking all of our land, and then we don't
and
have...
our women.
And our women. And our women.
Where
Danny?
Does it end?
Okay, real or fake headline here, Denny's. What do you think? Garbage bag full of diseased needles found in Florida hospital lobby.
Oh, good Lord.
I know Bird loves diseased needles.
You said it like that.
Loves them.
He does. I think that's fake.
You gotta go fake. You're right. He loves disease needles. He loves disease needles.
You must have heard me say that to you before.
Disease needles.
Like you'd like that.
All right, Virginia, is this a real or fake Florida headline? Florida man caught trying to sell stolen alligator to children's playground. Real or fake?
Wait, he stole the alligator? And then tried to sell it back to the same playground?
The alligator is stolen, and I don't know where he got it or if he stole it, but then he decided that, yeah, you know, where would be a good home for this? How about a kid's playground?
He tried to, all right.
Yeah, I think that's what's going on in the story here.
I mean, this is a tricky one because we do got lots of gators.
You do.
And it seems like every gator-type crime is just so goofy and over the top.
But is it so goofy?
Florida man and gators, it's like their official
free money.
They go
money,
together. Like,
they love each other.
Like shrimp and grits. They go so nice. I'm going to say it's real.
That is real, yeah.
Really? Yeah. I thought that was fake.
No, that was real.
I'm telling you, there's so many weird stories about Florida man doing weird things with gators.
Wow. Okay, what about this? Real or fake Florida headline. Florida man posing as a fake Walmart employee steals $2,000 worth of deli cold cuts. Is that real or fake, Denny's?
Oh. That's a lot of meat, because normally their meat's not that expensive.
Yeah.
Maybe it was the long con.
Hmm.
The long con. It's
like it's a con, but it takes time.
It's funny to hear you try to talk.
The long con.
Man, I feel so bad for your husband.
Everybody does. Happy birthday, Panda.
Oh, yeah, it's his birthday.
You're not getting out of this till you die.
Oh, God. What a chilling message to get on your birthday.
He was posing as an employee. I'm going to say that's real.
Gonna go real. That is fake.
Oh.
Come on. 2,000 worth of deli meat, Denny's?
Yeah.
You can't eat the meat before it goes bad, Denny's.
You're right.
I tricked you away with that long con.
That long, the comment. Conversation.
Long con.
Long con. You ain't hard. You ain't street.
Hi, Virginia, what do you think? Is this a real or a fake Florida headline? Florida couple arrested for having sexual relations while speeding on a motorcycle. Is that real or fake?
Sounds hot.
I think we all agree it sounds pretty hot.
Yeah. All right. Come on, baby. Ride my hog.
Oh, Kevin, yes.
Oh, wow.
I love it, Kevin. I love motorcycle, Kev.
Biker Kev.
That's biker terminology.
Biker Kev is awesome.
Yeah, biker terminology, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I dare you to go home and say that to Kim.
She'd be like, what hog?
That's not a hog.
You don't have a motorcycle and you don't have a hog.
You ain't riding nothing.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that's fake.
Gonna go fake on that, yes.
You're on fire over
there.
Yeah.
Three for for three right now.
I'm in the zone.
All right, Denny's got to keep up here.
Ugh.
Girls in the pocket. All right, real or fake, Florida headline. Santa Claus lookalike arrested for selling cocaine to undercover police officer. Did a Santa Claus look-alike do that?
Oh, it's going to be a white
Real
Christmas.
Real or fake?
It's going to be a white
Very white Christmas.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Why does Santa have so much energy?
That's how he gets around all those houses.
Yeah. Woo! You want to go around the globe and deliver presents all night?
You're right. Tell me those reindeers are getting some of Santa's dust.
Okay, real or fake, Denny's? What do you think?
That can't be real.
Okay.
I just can't accept it.
Okay, you're wrong again.
No!
Oh, damn.
Santa, no.
And you did so good in Joke Jury.
You pay then, and then you lose later. So that's what happened to me.
Final one for perfect score, Virginia. Florida man arrested for trying to steal Waffle House tattoo. Real or fake?
Feels real.
Yeah.
It feels Florida.
Much like the alligator, Waffle House is the same thing. Yeah.
You're right.
Florida man steal Waffle House tattoo.
I want it to be real, Kevin.
It's got all the buzzwords.
It's got all the buzzwords, and it is real.
Yay!
Oh, wow.
Florida.
So, what, did he get the tattoo and then try to run off with it?
Believe so, yeah.
Okay.
That's what happened.
Feels right.
Try to run off without paying. This happens a lot on TikTok. A lot of girls go to the hairdresser and then try to run out and get out before paying.
What?
And so now it's a whole thing on TikTok of beauticians like reading the Riot Act.
I saw that.
Chasing.
There was a guy that got twists. He got his hair braided.
There's a bunch of them.
Yeah.
There's a bunch of people that try to take off or leave before paying, and the beauticians will film them. It's a whole thing. It's fascinating. You'll go down a rabbit hole.
Okay. Real or fake Florida headline here. Denny's not doing great today.
I gotta redeem myself here.
Florida man turns himself into police claiming he's a werewolf, but he was actually just on meth. Is that real or fake?
Man, Bird loves werewolves.
Bird loves meth.
You know, meth is such a buzzword, too.
Yeah.
I don't love meth, the drug, but I do like
meth stories about others on meth. Not yourself.
I do love werewolves. Gosh.
Okay. What do you think here, Denny's?
Oh, no. I just don't want to get it wrong. Yeah. I'm going to say it's real.
You are going to go with real on that, and you are wrong again.
No!
No!
I thought he was three out of four. I thought he was trying to trick me with the werewolf.
Some weeks the bird just gets
us. He does. He's in my head this week.
Good.
I like staying in there.
Dang. I knew werewolf, too.
You knew.
Don't be so hard on yourself, bud.
Okay. Jeez, he's beating himself up.
All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes. Man, oh man, a big old mall in South Florida is in trouble. One of their anchor stores just shut its doors. I'll let you know who next.
More KVJ next on 97.9 WRMF. Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For a car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer? Come rest. Make the call. 844-411-1LAW.
Your floors can go from clean to dirty fast. From juice spills, whoops, to muddy paw prints, to little sticky finger marks. Good thing your Swiffer WetJet works fast too. Swiffer WetJet easily cleans everyday messes as quick as they happen. The next mess is right around the corner. So grab your Swiffer WetJet and just spray, push, all clean.
Want more speed? Then you're in luck, because Xfinity just increased their internet speeds, and they're faster than ever. Plus, with super fast internet and a reliable connection, you can do more of what you love whenever you want. More gaming, more downloading, more video chatting, and more cozy nights on the couch streaming your favorite movies and TV shows. If life with double the speed is sounding pretty awesome, that's because it is. It's time to get more out of your internet with faster speeds from Xfinity. Get 150 megabit Xfinity internet for only $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. That's double the speed for the same great price. Plus, for a limited time, learn how you can get a $100 prepaid card when you get more speed when you sign up online. Just go to Xfinity.com to switch today. Requires paperless billing and autopay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Equipment taxes and other charges extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and not guaranteed.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. Oh, I've got the appetite of 7 woolly mammoths. Oh, yeah. And Duncan's got you covered. And I was having a great heart-to-heart conversation with Sweet Denny's during commercial a few minutes ago about blueberry donuts at Duncan. He loves the blueberry donut. I love the blueberry donut. What donut speaks to you? What donut do you have in your heart? Let me know. I'd love to talk donuts with you. Duncan, too, they got a great app. You're going to get deals galore when you download that app, so make sure you do that. I'm helping you out with that. I'm Jay Bird, and I run on Duncan.
Want your child to go to summer camp, but afraid you can't afford it? Did you know you can apply for one of the more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships available right now for Palm Beach County children? Now is the time to apply for camp scholarships. The deadline is April 12th. To learn more, go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Well, I certainly have enjoyed my education in Kia. I didn't realize how technologically advanced they were now. I didn't realize that Kia had stolen away one of those German engineers from Audi, and all of these Kias are redesigned and sleek and technologically advanced and luxurious. It is not your mama's Kia. You need to get to Greenway Kia and go test drive one of these vehicles. I'm telling you, once you sit in one of these Greenway Kia vehicles, you will get it. And you'll be like, oh my gosh, that's what she was talking about. These are nice. The Tellurides, the Sportages, the K5s, the Fortes, even the Soul. Oh my gosh, I was in the Soul the other day. What a cute car. They're so sleek and they're so advanced. It is not the Kia you knew just 5 years ago. And if you're making $350 a week, they want to approve you. Go to KiaWestPalmBeach.com or call 1-800-NEW-KIAS.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Starting off with some patchy fog this morning, but that'll burn away this afternoon. For today, 80 degrees, we're partly sunny. Could pick up a shower or a storm, mainly into Palm Beach County. Into the Treasure Coast, we're generally dry. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
Sponsored by Allstate. Some people just know the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate, not one based on anyone else. So if you drive safely, you could save money. Good to know. Visit Allstate.com or call for a quote today.
Wait, KVJ is on TikTok?
Oh, you've got to see this.
Now back to the KVJ show on 97.9 WRMF.
What do you think our malls in South Florida are going to look like in 10 years?
Condos where rich people own?
A lot of them are really going through it right now, trying to figure out what the heck are we going to be. And I saw that one of the anchor stores just closed down at a major South Florida mall. The Sears at the Gardens Mall shut its doors for good on Friday.
Dang.
I'm over here thinking they closed down 10 years ago. Sears is still open?
You can see it when you go in there, because I go in there for like watch repair. It was the bomb for watch repair, and it was so cheap. You could shoot off a gun and not hit anybody. There's never anybody in that store.
As a little kid, I would get major anxiety going into a Sears. I hated it. They scared me because of the Adam Walsh story.
Oh, okay. Shoot. Yeah, that's true.
It scared me.
It's crazy how much they have fallen off. There's only two stores that remain open in Florida now for Sears. One in Coral Gables, one in Orlando. And that is it. And you're talking about, man, I mean, Sears was it. They had a ton of stores. In fact, if you rewind the clock just to 2018 when they filed for bankruptcy, they had 687 stores in America. They now have 13. They have closed 600 plus stores in 4 years.
So what happened? Did they just start to suck, or is their products crappy?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of things that, you know, just happened with it. You know, they just stopped talking to American consumers and what they wanted. There was the ability to order a lot of your stuff. There were specialty stores. They used to be the place where you go to get a little bit of everything. And
you're right. I don't think they kept up with them just putting themselves out there.
They didn't keep up with the times, and they just got bested. Other people came along and figured out how to do it better. Your Macy's, your Nordstrom, your Bloomingdale's, all those other anchors. I mean, they're not seeing as much foot traffic either.
But they're surviving in an industry that's changing.
They're barely surviving, and I think marked for death.
I mean, honestly, since I was a kid, I thought Sears sucked with or without the Adam Wall story. Yeah. For a kid, you're like, oh, cool. I get to look at dryers. The funnest thing to do at Sears was to go on the escalator.
Pretty much done. You know, when the Gardens Mall opened up in 1988, there were three anchors. There was Macy's, which is struggling. Just this last week, there were talks about what Macy's is going to be doing. So they're on the ropes. There was Sears that just closed, and Burdine's, which is gone. I mean, that isn't a statement of what American malls are today. Those were the anchor stores. That these are the tried and true. We're building this mall around these three.
I tell you what, though. I know I always go to food. Every time I go to a mall food court, that seems to be jumping. The food court, I don't think, has lost a step.
They got to reinvent themselves, and that might be it. I think the malls I know of, Boynton Beach is on the ropes. I think that's for sale. They're going to refigure that and probably put a lot of housing in there. They're redoing what is or was City Place. It's now the Square. They're the Mall Wellington Green, the Gardens Mall. So all of these malls are really going to have to do something. And food options seems to be good. A little bit of housing in there. Have it kind of be the place where you would live and work. And so the next 10 years is going to be fascinating to see, because you look at a lot of these malls and they're on big swaths of land, which is very valuable here in South Florida. And they're the centerpieces of a lot of communities. You look at Aventura, that is a big mall, you know. So what's going to happen to these places in the next 10 years, and how are they going to look?
First things first, bring back Orange Julius and put them in every single mall.
Oh, you think that's the secret?
Take it back to the old school. Start getting artists to perform in the mall like they did back in the day. they were artists known as mall performers, and they got Tiffany, Debbie Gibson, stuff like that.
Oh, it might be a mix where maybe they do put a little performance area and they do start having a certain level of performer come to these malls, but I don't know a mall right now that is not radical. I mean, look at downtown the Gardens. That's a mall area. They are radically trying to reconfigure that space. Every mall I can think of in South Florida, for the most part, there are a few that maybe are untouched right now, but they're really trying to figure out how to save this thing. And it's on life support.
Oren Julius's.
Orange Julius.
Oren?
Oren?
Who's Oren Julius?
I don't know what I just said. I think I had a stroke.
We figured out what an Orange Julius is. It's just an eggnog with fresh squeezed orange juice in it.
Fresh squeezed? No.
All it is.
I hate eggnog.
Well, I guess you don't. You thought you knew. That's all it is.
Is Virginia wrong?
When is she right?
Is she just throwing things out? Are you? If I Google, that means you win.
It's nothing. It's nothing more than eggnog and fresh squeezed orange juice, and it's shaken vigorously.
Okay. Is Virginia right on this?
I'm Googling. She beat me.
Will Orange Julius save every mall in America?
Of course not, Kevin.
Well, Virginia was actually right on one thing. It was about her mom. It saved her life, too. She'll tell you how. Coming up next. Jaybird says more Orange Julius stores will save America's malls. Virginia says that Orange Julius is actually eggnog.
You're going to have to play a theme song. Virginia is wrong.
Whatever. I made it over the holidays.
She deserves the theme song. I'm on the Orange Julius site. It says there is no eggnog in here. It doesn't say that really, but there's no eggnog.
What is it, Orange Julius?
It's smooth. Oh, okay. I can't. My eyes.
He can't read.
It's a long article, Kev. It's got... It's like a milkshake. You asked me stuff. I'm not prepared.
It's eggnog and orange juice. Fight me.
I am. I'm fighting
you. Well, you're fighting me with no weapons.
Because you've thrown...
It is a blend of frozen orange juice, concentrate, milk, vanilla, sugar, and ice.
Huh.
That's it. I don't see anything about eggnog.
Yeah.
It's got eggnog in it.
No. Not according to the official recipe.
You have so much power. Just shut up for Mike.
Somebody did actually Google, is Orange Julius healthy?
It's got powdered egg whites in it. I'm looking at the recipe. Powdered egg whites. That's eggnog, homie. Look it up.
All right.
Telling you, I made it.
I've officially surrendered. This is the part where you have the person on the stand and they start losing their mind, and you just let them talk.
Yeah. Not only am I better looking than you, I'm smarter than you. It's got powdered egg whites in it.
Okay, so it is nothing but eggnog. Virginia just is. She's just all over. Even though everybody's saying Virginia's wrong, that's not eggnog.
Oh, she don't read the comments because she's all scared that they're going to call her wrong because she's wrong.
Well, go read it. It says powdered egg whites.
Okay. Somebody said eggnog is just egg, sugar, cream, vanilla, and spices. But I don't know if an Orange Julius has these spices. And you said it does have egg, Virginia?
They both have egg.
Okay.
Eggnog and Orange Julius. Well, they both have egg in them.
If eggnog doesn't have egg in it, they're liars.
I think we can agree that eggnog should have egg in it.
Well, it's questionable as to whether or not Virginia is right or not on Orange Julius being nothing but eggnog, but she was right on one thing, and it was her mom's health. You suspected that your mom might have a little bit of a heart blockage, Virginia, and you insisted that she get tested.
When me and my sister went to go see her last year, we were walking through the Riverwalk where she lives in San Antonio. And, you know, my sister Maggie is a nurse.
Sister.
She's the one that alerted me to it. She goes, look at mom. Look at mom. And I'm like, all right, I'm looking. Mm-hmm. What am I looking for?
Right.
And my sister's like, look, she's doing this thing called pursed lip breathing.
Okay.
And she's struggling and she's sweaty and we haven't been walking that far. And yes, it's Africa hot. It was so hot in San Antonio.
Okay.
But it was a dry heat and nobody was sweating except my mom. And my sister goes, mom has a cardiac issue. And I was like, wait, what? And then I looked at my mom. And you know how sometimes, like, I don't know how to describe it. I do feel like it's kind of a witchy moment. Something flooded over me and told me in that moment, your mom's got a heart issue. Your mom's got a heart blockage. Something is going on with your mom. And I knew it. In that moment, I'm like, my sister is right.
Well, that's how you knew, because your sister's a nurse.
It flooded over me. I can't explain it. It felt like a premonition. It felt like angels in heaven, maybe her mother, who had passed away from the same freaking thing, sent me a message and said, look, she's got to go get this checked. There's an issue. And so I begged her to go, and she kept canceling the appointments. Mm-hmm. And then I stepped in and called the doctor, and I'm like, you've got to get her in. And she was procrastinating and didn't want to do it. She even went to one appointment. I don't know what kind of goofy doctor looked at her heart and said there was nothing bad.
Dr. Goofy?
Dr. Goofy told her she's fine, and I'm like, no, that's not right. That's not right. And turns out it wasn't right. She has something going on with her heart, and they rushed her to the hospital yesterday. She's in the hospital right now.
Is she okay?
Got her on right now. You can actually ask her. Hello, Linda.
Yes.
How are you feeling today?
I'm okay, but I'm in the hospital.
What did they say was going on with your heart?
It's something called an AFib, where the top part of the heart is beating like wildly fast and the bottom half is beating regular. And it comes and goes. So when they tested me before, it didn't show up. And Maggie said it does come and go, and people walking around with it sometimes don't know they have it. And I guess I've been having it off and on, and nobody caught it until this last time I went into the doctor Monday, and he said he didn't like the way my heart sounded, did an EKG, and said, you're going to the ER right now. He called my husband from the other side of town. He had to drive over and come take me to the hospital because he wouldn't let me, doctor wouldn't let me drive.
So was it something that if you hadn't gone in, it could have taken your life?
I don't know. The doctor was afraid I could have a heart attack.
Yeah, I think people drop dead from stuff like that. And it happens when, if it happens when you're by yourself, then it's lights out, baby.
Well, it's good that you're in the hospital now getting all the proper, you know, tests and all that.
Amen.
Yes, they're going to do a operation thing today where they're going to go in and make sure there's no blood clots in my heart. And then if there's no clot there, then they're going to do an ablation, which is will take care of the top flutter part and make it go away and make it stabilize.
Okay.
So right now they've got me on a drip to keep my heart, you know, steady and not going fast.
You got this. Yeah. Everything's gonna work out great.
This is modern medicine is really great, and they can fix stuff like this very easily.
They do. Mm-hmm. Someone in my family has an issue like you're describing, and you get right back on track. It's great that, you know, Virginia and her sister saw this and said something. The fact that you're getting it done now is a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm glad it finally showed up.
Yeah.
Because it's something that's intermittent sometimes, and the EKG showed the blockage, but it didn't show the AFib the first time they did it.
Okay.
So this last time I went to the doctor, he flipped out and sent me to the ER.
That's how me and Maggie felt when we were watching you walk in the river walk in San Antonio. We knew something wasn't right, and that's when we were like, Mom, you've got to go. I'm so glad that you got it, and I'm glad you're not dead in your backyard in the garden.
Jeez.
Me too.
Yeah.
Amen.
Okay. Amen.
All right. Well, get better fast, okay, Linda?
Thank you.
We love you.
Yeah, we're thinking about you.
Yeah. Yeah, honestly, you know, I know we talk about it, but for real, I'd tell everybody, go get that free heart scan at Life Imaging FLA.
I tried to get her to come here. I said, Mom, it's free. I'll take you to Life Imaging FLA. Let them look at your heart. She would not come. She said no. She didn't want to travel. And
yeah, that's easy.
No. I have relatives like that, too, man. They just will not go to a medical facility.
Well, if anybody wants to do it, it is free with just a few minimum requirements from your cell. Just call #250, say the key. Keyword free heart scan. That's #250. Keyword free heart scan.
We are South Florida. The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
It's a groovable feast at Universal Mardi Gras, February 3rd through April 7th. Enjoy the international flavors of Carnival with an ice cold Coca-Cola Zero Sugar at the hottest party in town. This is your bead throwing, concert going, non-stop festival of fun.
Florida residents, get 2 days free when you buy a two-park, one-day park-to-park ticket. Dig into the details at UniversalOrlando.com. Not available at front gate. Used by 6/26/24. Restrictions apply.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer, and now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
No way. Puerto Tropicana's open till midnight?
What? Grab me a Trappy Chop.
Done.
Ah, forgot the cheesy yuca bites.
Got it.
Good looking out, bro.
I didn't say they were for you, though.
Puerto Tropicana. Real food, real fresh, and now real late. Open till midnight. Hours may vary by location.
I'm Mark Anajar.
I'm Glenn Levine.
I'm Ellie Anajar.
And we're Anajar and Levine. Experience the Anajar and Levine difference by calling us with any of your legal needs. Call 1-800-747-FREE for a free consultation and take back control of your life.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Are you having a problem with your weight? so many people in life do. And sometimes you need a little extra help because dieting and exercise is not getting it done. Wellington Anti-Aging is in your corner. And even if you have had stubborn fat holding on for decades, you can get rid of it with the power of the pharmaceuticals offered at Wellington Anti-Aging. They can get that weight off of you to live a healthier life. And they can do other great things like balance out your hormones. That's very key. It does establish your metabolism, your energy levels, your libido, all these great things you can regulate. And it can also help you with any kind of symptoms from menopause, like hot flashes and night sweats. Plus, it can even fend off some long-term health complications like osteoporosis, heart disease, type 2 diabetes, even some forms of cancer. And they even do the cosmetic stuff like age spots, wrinkles. If you want to look better and feel better, just click on to WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly!
Hi, I'm attorney Robert Rubenstein, and this is Rubenstein's Rules for Personal Injury. Rule number 11. Truck accidents require special attention. Sometimes trucking companies put their drivers in a difficult position, and accidents happen. Driving without sleep can be as dangerous as drunk driving. Loads can be too heavy. Evidence needs to be preserved for inspection without delay. Some trucking companies hide insurance, but we know how to find it. Call Rubenstein Law at 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Offices in Palm Beach and throughout Florida.
This is the day of the big sale at your gift shop.
Welcome in.
So this isn't just a big day for your business. It's a big day for the network keeping it all connected. That is, if it can handle the pressure.
Next in line, please.
So is it possible to get business internet you can really count on? It is. With 99.9% network reliability from Comcast Business. It's like this neat little bow.
Do you like that gift wrap?
Really ties it all together. Reliable internet for your business. It's not just possible. It's happening. Comcast Business. Powering possibilities.
Get started with internet and security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get an $800 prepaid card on a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call or go online today to switch to Comcast Business. Ends 5/5/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Get ready, Boca Raton. The South Florida Food Fest and Craft Fair is going on all weekend long at South County Regional Park near Sunset Cove Amphitheater. Dozens of food vendors offering a la carte menus where all food is only $5 or less. Enjoy live music, food and craft vendors, a full liquor bar with craft beer and cocktails. A day filled with unforgettable flavors. Don't miss the South Florida Food Fest and Craft Fair this weekend. For tickets and more info, go to southfloridafoodfest.com.
You know, when you're the best, you should get awards for being just that. And that's what happened just this week in New Orleans at the National Movers Convention. The Good Greek Spiro and his team from Good Greek Moving and Storage and Good Greek Enterprises, they took the award for the top mover in the nation. Do you know how many movers were competing for that title? Good Greek won it, and we're so proud to be affiliated with them. For over 20 years, they've been our marketing partner. We've sent people to them for everything, and now they do it all, not just moving and storing.
Yeah, they do everything, and so it makes your move a lot easier. You got the best of the best, and they're that way because of their attention to detail, the fact that they give you good customer service, and they take care of your stuff when they're moving it.
Yeah, when my dad moves back down to Florida, we're using Good Greek to get all of his stuff down here.
The juicy daddy is coming back to Florida?
I'm going to try to make him feel guilty enough.
Oh, please, come home, juicy daddy. Good Greek will move him. They'll move anybody here. Seriously, they do it nationwide. They do it local. They also do everything from insurance to your mortgage to real estate services. They can help the juicy daddy with every angle of his move. Go to goodgreek.com because it's all Good Greek to us.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference.
Call 1-800-747-FREE.
Don't forget the After the Show podcast, coming up live and uncensored. Get it wherever you get your podcasts. Now more of the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Rosalind had sent in a nice little message here that her mom had gone through the same thing your mom did, Virginia, 3 weeks ago, and she's doing great now.
Aw, so, good news.
Yeah, a little positivity for you, and Jaybird's got a little bit more. He's going to wrap up our KVJ Show with his little thought for the day. That is coming up after Linkin Park.
It starts with one thing. I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. I'm designed to try to explain in due time. All I know, time is a valuable thing. Watch it fly by as the pendulum swings. Watch it count down to the end of the day. The clock takes life away. It's so unreal. Didn't look out below. Watch the time go right out the window. Trying to hold on to, didn't even know. I wasted it all just to watch you. It all fell apart. What it meant to be will eventually be a memory of a time I tried so hard and got so far. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. One thing, I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. I designed this rhyme to remind myself how I tried so hard. In spite of the way you were mocking me, acting like I was part of your property. Remembering all the times you fought with me, I'm surprised it got so. Things aren't the way they were before. You wouldn't even recognize me anymore. Not that you knew me back then, but it all comes back to me in the end. You kept everything inside, and even though I tried, it all fell apart. What it meant to me will eventually be a memory. I tried so hard and got so far, but in the end, it doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all, but in the end, it doesn't even matter. I put my trust in you, just as far as I can go. For all this, there's only one thing you should know. I've put my trust.
Like this from Leslie. She went and got that free heart scan coming up on 50. It was all clear, but she said, I love the peace of mind, and now I am pushing my entire family to go in and get it done. If you want to do it as well, from your cell, call pound 250, say the keyword free heart scan.
I get a clean bill of health for my heart. Instantly going to get a pizza and a big jug of whiskey.
You're next. You need to go down there and do it.
Yeah, I'm on the road to getting all that done.
Okay, good.
All right, Bird, got a little positivity going on here. Why don't you bring it home with your thought for the day?
I do. I have a little poem I wrote for your mom.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Let me put on my reading glasses. I hope this poem will ease your mind. I know in my heart you'll be fine. You will heal and feel like you're brand new. Just want to say that we love you.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.